Today's Auburn broadcast will begin in 12 minutes. Today's Auburn broadcast will begin in 10 minutes. Today's Auburn broadcast will begin in 8 minutes. Thank you. Today's Auburn broadcast will begin in 5 minutes. Four minutes till start of broadcast. This broadcast will begin in 3 minutes. Here's your 2 minute time check. Mark. Here comes your 1 minute time check for this Auburn broadcast. Mark. Thirty seconds till broadcast. Mark.
Here's a steal by Barkley. Barkley takes it right by Master to guard. All the way to...
Beautiful steal. And he goes wire to wire. Stefanino for the big
Taylor unloads a three-pointer.
Yeah!
Baseball pass. Front court, Bryan Smith. Baseline, eight-footer in and out. No good. Oh, my goodness. Baseball is down by Porter. Oh, my goodness. Behind the back. Gone. Over the shoulder by Bryan Smith. This place is going wacko.
That was absolutely unbelievable.
I love it. Keep the pressure on.
Down in Auburn, Alabama.
Let the confetti fall.
History has been made. The Auburn Tigers are going to the Final Four.
Are we having fun yet?
Jabari inside to the basket. Dunks it and gets fouled. A resounding dunk for an SEC championship. And the celebration begins at Auburn's Neville Arena.
Welcome to the jungle.
Well, here we are again. Last Tuesday, Auburn was in a must-win situation with Missouri at Neville Arena. The Orange and Blue Tigers responded with their most complete win in the SEC. Saturday, Auburn suffered another heartbreaker at Vanderbilt. And with four games remaining in the SEC regular season, Auburn needs a victory in the worst way at home tonight. Good evening and War Eagle from Neville Arena. With eight-time Hall of Fame coach Sonny Smith and Jacob Hillman, I'm Andy Bergeron. Vanderbilt broke Auburn's collective heart last Saturday. A driving basket with 0.8 seconds remaining was the game winner for the Commodores. Auburn sits in fifth place in the SEC standings, tied with Vandy at 8-6. After Ole Miss tonight, Auburn goes to fourth place Kentucky, first place Alabama, before the regular season finale against fourth place Tennessee. Auburn beat Ole Miss 82-73 last month in Oxford. Wendell Green Jr. led Auburn with 23 points, 5 rebounds and 7 assists. Jani Broome recorded his 7th double-double. The Rebels are 2-12 in SEC play. Their wins came against South Carolina and Georgia. Most believe Auburn must get to 10 wins in SEC play to secure a bid to the NCAA tournament. The Tigers can't afford to stumble tonight against Ole Miss. The CBNS Bank Countdown to Tip-Off starts now.
Exclusive pregame coverage of the Tigers begins now with the CBNS Bank Countdown to Tip-Off. Coming up, analysis, interviews, and a look around college basketball. At CBNS Bank, we've been family, community, and financially strong since we began in 1906. Visit cbsbank.com. Alongside Hall of Fame coach Sonny Smith, here's the voice of the Tigers, Andy Burcham.
Neville Arena is filling up for this late night start between Auburn and Ole Miss. And we welcome you to the Plains, along with Jacob Hillman, an eight-time Hall of Fame coach, Sonny Smith. I'm Andy Burcham. Well, this is very close to what we were a week ago at home in a must-win game. Auburn responded last week with its best win, I think, of the SEC. With the win against Missouri, they need to do something very similar tonight against an upset-minded Ole Miss team, Sonny.
Yeah, you said it, upset-minded. They are a tough team to play because they are a tempo control type team. If they can get control of a game, they can be tough all the way through. So it'd be early to be good to get off to a good early start in this game.
Coming up tonight on the CBNS Bank Countdown to Tip-Off, you will hear from Ira Bowman with the scout. You'll hear from Jalen Williams as he talks about his float shot. He'll explain. And you'll hear from Bruce Pearl coming up as well. You will hear both Ira and BP talk about the multiple defensive schemes of Kermit Davis, from the man to the 1-3-1 to matchup zone. He will throw the kitchen sink at the Auburn Tigers tonight.
And he doesn't stay in any one defense long enough for you to solve it. That's what makes it tough. He'll play the 1-3-1 for three possessions and then go to something else. So you better be ready for everything going in. A well-scouted team, we always are.
All right, with that in mind then, Sonny, talk about the importance of Wendell Green Jr. and Trey Donaldson, Auburn's two-point guards, to recognize the defense that Ole Miss is in when they're coming down the floor.
Well, that's what their defensive schemes are all about, for you not to be able to recognize them after one or two possessions. And they get in and out extremely well. And, by the way, they play them all well. If they could rebound at them, they would probably play them a lot more.
It's an Auburn team that needs to win tonight because we know what the schedule is like for Auburn after tonight. Kentucky, where Auburn hasn't won since 1988. The last time Auburn won, the man sitting to my right was on the sideline, the other sideline for the Auburn Tigers. Then at Alabama, the best team in the SEC, and home against Tennessee. Auburn's got to get two, perhaps three wins out of this last four. Tonight is an absolute must.
Sonny. It's a must, and this place makes a must a little bit more of a thing for us because we are so good here on some nights. And when you play a tempo control team, you better be good.
Auburn will come in. Now listen, Auburn beat Ole Miss 82-73 in January. Got a terrific game from Wendell Green Jr., 23-5-7. A double-double from Jani Broome, 12 and 5 assists from Jalen Williams. Those three have to come to play tonight for the Tigers.
Yeah. Well, somebody said to me today, what's good about Auburn? I said, well, when our guards play good, we are one of the better teams in this conference and maybe one of the best in the country.
Auburn faces very tough competition down the stretch. The road has been very tough for Auburn. And Auburn goes on the road for back-to-back games starting Saturday at Kentucky and then at Alabama before coming home against Tennessee. Bruce Pearl doesn't pull any punches with his team. He tells this team how important every game is with regard to the SEC tournament and certainly the NCAA tournament at this point.
Well, I think this team will be ready to play. They're at home where they've been extremely successful. And they also know the importance of the game because he's drilled that into them all week. And I think we're going to see a good Auburn start.
It is a healthy Auburn ball club tonight. Of course, Chance Westry has been out for quite some time. He doesn't even dress for the games anymore. But as a result, Auburn is still a very healthy team as it gets ready for tonight's game against Ole Miss. This medical report brought to you by East Alabama Health. Need emergency care? Check out the new freestanding emergency department located in a new Auburn Medical Pavilion in the Auburn Research Park. Jani Broome played a little bit hurt on Saturday. He, of course, stumbled a bit last Tuesday with the ankle, but then had the flu for 2 days going into Vanderbilt. Didn't seem to hurt him. He was terrific last Saturday night in Nashville. It's already been a successful day on the plains. Already a win for Auburn on the plains today. And after tonight, everybody will have four games remaining in the SEC regular season. To tell you all about it, to our partner, here's Jacob Hillman.
Thank you, Andy. And it's two games already in progress, and another will begin as Auburn and Ole Miss tip off. And both those games in progress could have major impact on Auburn's positioning in Nashville at the SEC tournament. We'll update it all right now.
From the home of the reigning conference champions to every corner of the SEC, let's go around the most exciting conference in college basketball. This is the Toyota SEC Report. No matter your destination, Toyota goes with you. Toyota, let's go places.
Like Andy said, only four games remaining for all teams after tonight. So let's go through some of the SEC standings. At the top, it's Alabama at 13-1, Texas A&M's at 13-2. But here's where things get mushed up a little bit. Kentucky sits at 9-5, and the Wildcats right now are leading at Florida 61-59 with 8:10 to go in the second half. And those Gators are sitting right behind the Auburn Tigers at 7-7, Auburn at 8-6 in the SEC. So you could see those teams all come together and be very close as we head into the last few games of the season. Then it's number 11 Tennessee at 9-6, and then Vanderbilt at 8-6 has a tiebreaker over Auburn with that win on Saturday. And the Commodores are getting everything from LSU, who's 1-13 in the SEC. The Tigers lead it 58-54 in Baton Rouge with 9:33 to go in the second half. Later on tonight, those top-ranked Crimson Tide will take on South Carolina in Colonial Life Arena, and the Crimson Tide really need several wins because Texas A&M is right on their heels, and it could be trouble for the Tide if Texas A&M gets them next Saturday in College Station. Those are your scores in the SEC for tonight. Like I said, LSU leading Vanderbilt 61-54 with 9:16 to go in the second half in Baton Rouge. And Kentucky had a big lead over Florida, but leads Florida 61-59 with 7:57 to go in the second half. Now, what's on the menu is presented by Whataburger, introducing the new Whataburger Breakfast Bowl. That's right, one convenient bowl filled to the brim with a fresh baked biscuit, scrambled eggs, crispy hash browns, creamy gravy, shredded cheddar jack cheese, and your choice of sausage or bacon. Available for a limited time. What's on the menu tonight? A 60-second scout of Ole Miss with Ira Bowman, and Jalen Williams takes center stage for a player profile. Plus, Andy Burcham's exclusive sit-down with Bruce Pearl, Coach Sonny Smith's keys to the games, your starting lineups, and eventually, tip-off. All coming up when the CBNS Bank Countdown to Tip-Off continues in a moment.
CBNS Bank has a long history of stability and a legacy of serving our community's needs for generations. You could say we know a thing or two about tradition. We've been family, community, and financially strong since we began in 1906. Being a team player is part of our culture. That's why at CBNS Bank, we are proud supporters and huge fans of Auburn basketball. Whoa, Regal, hey! Visit cbsbank.com today. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Did you know the average piece of produce travels 1,500 miles to reach your plate? When you buy local, you shorten your supply chain and reduce fuel emissions to contribute to a more sustainable world. I'm Ellie Watson, the director of Sweet Grown Alabama, a program designed to help you find locally grown products. Visit sweetgrownalabama.org to search for locally grown produce, meat, honey, and more in your area.
How are you the ultimate Auburn fan?
Because I got this air horn installed in my throat.
Pretty sick, right?
Yes. You look really sick. What doctor would even do this?
Doctor? I did this myself. I mean, I can't swallow whole food, but still.
Wait, what?
Just gotta plow through it.
Hey, can I get a couple of soups up here? What about some chamomile tea?
Don't be that guy. Get a fan card. The smart way to be the ultimate Tigers fan. Just go to auburncards.com.
We've invented a new messaging system using the crisp sounds of Bud Light. Crisp Code, Lesson 86. This is how you say, "Gee Willikers, it's a hot one." Let's cool down with some Bud Lights. That's it for today. Bud Light, crisp.
Enjoy responsibly. Bud Light Beer, Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
You're listening to Auburn Basketball. Now more of the CBNS Bank Countdown to Tip-Off.
Jacob Hillman here with you courtside at Neville Arena to tell you StubHub is the easiest way to experience every Tigers game. Check the virtual view, score your seats, and get your tickets delivered instantly. StubHub is the official ticketing partner of Auburn Athletics. StubHub, be there. Only one regular season game left at Neville Arena after tonight, so check out StubHub if you want to be here March 4th against Tennessee. The Ole Miss Rebels are coached by Kermit Davis, who is in his fifth season in Oxford. Auburn defeated Ole Miss back in early January, 82-73, in a game with 11 lead changes and 4 ties. A 48-point second half for the Tigers, led by Wendell Green Jr.'s 18 second-half points, helped Auburn take control at the Pavilion. The last time the Tigers were in front of the jungle, head coach Bruce Pearl called the matchup with Missouri a must-win, and he says tonight's game is no different. Ira Bowman gives us his 60-second scout of Ole Miss.
Ole Miss is a team that runs great offense. I think they're better than what their record always presents. They come in, obviously, well-coached, and they're going to be have a chip on their shoulder, as always. They beat us here a couple years ago, I know, in COVID year, so I know our guys have to be lined up and ready to defend for 40 minutes.
Talk about facing their multiple defenses that you see out of a Kermit Davis team.
Well, Coach Davis does that. I mean, he changes up the rhythm of the game a lot. Obviously, they're known for their man-to-man, but the 1-3-1 back into variations of a 2-3. So it's just not to be – we have to continue to be aggressive versus it, not be passive, not sit back and be on our heels and attack as they change the defenses. We've been playing better as of late. I think we've been getting a lot of paint touches and sharing the ball. I think with most of the stuff, it's not letting the ball stick on offense. It's like the more the ball has energy and it gets off from one guy to the X, and guys wanting to have the hockey assist more than the regular assist, it'll help the offense move better and we'll play better.
Heard that term a lot, the hockey assist. For those that are unaware, what does the hockey assist mean to Auburn basketball?
Well, I mean, in layman's terms, it is like I got the ball. I'm not worried about throwing it to, making a hard pass. I won't skip it to somebody that I think is open. I'm going to make the easy pass to the next guy, and that guy will give it to the guy who's going to make the shot. So sometimes it doesn't come up in the stat book that you actually led to the basket, but your willingness to make the easy play is what actually leads to the offense being more efficient.
But the last time the Tigers were at home, they dished out a season high during SEC play, 21 assists, including 9 from Wendell Green Jr. Against Missouri. The 60-Second Scout is presented by the Raymond J. Harbert College of Business. Accelerate your career with an online MBA from the Harbert College of Business. Learn why they're ranked among the nation's best at harbert.auburn.edu. Well, senior forward Jalen Williams has submitted his role in this Auburn offense as one of its primary scorers, being able to score inside and out, averaging 10.9 points per game this season. Williams had a big game the first time around, with Ole Miss scoring 12 points, assisting on 5 baskets, grabbing 5 rebounds, and forcing 5 steals. Andy Burcham sits down with Jalen Williams for tonight's player profile.
Jalen, when you're playing a team for a second time in a season, how much do you think back to that game, and does it come to your mind at all during this game tonight?
I really don't think much about it, because usually, like, sometimes they're not really close to each other, and we have got so much better as a team, as a unit. But, like, I mean, we'll watch, like, as a team, like, the film of, like, everybody. Like, I'm familiar with, like, the scout, that the what the guys are good at, or what they struggle with, or, like, what hand they like to drive with. But, like, for the most part, I really don't look back at that game as much, because, I mean, like, we moved past and we learned we got so much better as a team that, like, we just do what we do now, and then we'll be fine.
Your mid lane shot, teardrop or hook or whatever, do you have a name for it? And how long have you had that shot in your arsenal?
I call it a float. Midge and I do it a lot. This is like, we argue about who has the better float. Obviously I have the better float, but I mean, I've been doing it since like high school. I mean, just posting up. Well, in high school, I really didn't like to post up and do it. I always try to be a guard in high school. I always try to go to work. But more so in college, I really noticed that, like, that's like one of my go-to shots. And like, it's easy for me. It's hard to contest because you don't know when I'm gonna go up or if I'm gonna pass it out or create for others.
Well, Jalen's float has certainly been pretty automatic, and as automatic as they come. And he's coming off the game at Vanderbilt where he scored 17 points on 8 of 12 shooting. Just because the weather's chilly doesn't mean Alabama farmers aren't busy growing high-quality products. Visit sweetgrownalabama.org to make your next Tigers watch party a slam dunk. Find farm-fresh greens, meats, and more at sweetgrownalabama.org. Up next, Andy Burcham's exclusive sit-down with head coach Bruce Pearl ahead of Auburn and Ole Miss at Neville Arena. This is the Auburn Sports Network.
Get your game day started with the CBNS Bank Countdown to Tip-Off on the Auburn Sports Network. 30 minutes before each Auburn basketball game, get a breakdown of the matchups, player profiles, a 60-second scout of the opponent, SEC report, and our exclusive pregame interview with head coach Bruce Pearl. CBNS Bank has been family, community, and financially strong since 1906. The CBNS Bank Countdown to Tip-Off, only on the Auburn Sports Network.
How are you the ultimate Auburn fan?
Because I got this air horn installed in my throat.
Pretty sick, right?
Yes, you look really sick. What doctor would even do this?
Doctor? I did this myself.
I mean, I can't swallow whole food, but
still. Wait, what?
Just gotta plow through it.
Hey, can I get a couple of soups up here?
What about some chamomile tea?
Don't be that guy. Get a fan card. The smart way to be the ultimate Tigers fan. Just go to auburncards.com.
It takes hard work to be the best in the game. Planning, commitment, resilience, sweat. That's why Old Dominion Freight Line, the number one national LTL carrier for quality, works hard to be the best in the game and is proud to support those striving to be the best in theirs. Old Dominion Freight Line, official freight carrier of Auburn Athletics, helping the world keep promises.
The celebration begins at Auburn's Neville Arena.
The game has changed, and the future of Auburn Athletics now demands a strong name, image, and likeness program. I'm Andy Burcham, and I urge you to support On to Victory, the name, image, and likeness collective for Auburn student athletes. Please take this opportunity to improve the lives of our players and give our teams the best chance of success. Learn more at ontovictory.com.
Ford presents our exclusive pregame visit with head coach Bruce Pearl. At Auburn, we revere our traditions. Ford has a tradition too, building trucks that are smart, dependable, and built Ford tough. That's why Ford F-150 is the official truck of the Auburn Tigers. Here's Andy Burchin with Coach Pearl.
How much does the first game against Ole Miss play a factor into tonight's game in your mind?
It plays a factor for sure. I'll tell you what, Andy, we played well over there, and we played well at both ends of the floor. And I don't know that Ole Miss, looking at them, I've seen them play better. So I think, Ole Miss will look at that game and say, hey, they were better than we were that night. But you know what? We contributed to it. They didn't play great. So hopefully we had, something to do that. Some of the things that they do defensively, they've changed up a little bit. They're being a little bit more aggressive with their man-to-man. They're trapping a little bit more. They double-team the post. They didn't do any of that stuff to us last time. They've been doing it. How we handle it, whether they do it this time, we'll have to see. They've always played the 1-3-1. We'll attack it the same way we attacked it, just out of spacing, and hopefully don't turn the ball over, because Ole Miss really relies on turning you over. They do a great job in transition, and so our ability to take care of the basketball tonight's important.
If they continue to double the post, what is the key to counter that?
Well, get the ball in there in good, deep, advantage-disadvantage situations. Having spacing for the pass out, it's not been something that Jani's been very effective with. And in fact, I would expect him to get double-teamed all the time, because he's a good scorer down there. You can't handle him down there one-on-one. But when they do come down on him, he's turned the ball over some. And so, we've got to just do a better job of handling it and taking advantage of the double team.
Take a look at this Ole Miss offense. They're big on the perimeter. I mean, their guards are big on the perimeter. How do you counter that?
Well, I mean, Matthew Morrell would probably start for anybody at the two spot. First-team all-conference caliber player. They're big and athletic at the three. They're young, but it's great size at point guard. And, we have smaller guards, so using our quickness and speed. One of the things that we got to do is we got to do a good job at the point of attack with our ball screens. We can't give their guards too much space. Our bigs have got to provide help. Our guys off the ball have got to tag the big back, and we're going to see about 75% ball screen tonight from Ole Miss.
Take a look at this game and where it stands with the last four games, SEC. Top four. I mean, you're very open with your ball club about the importance of every one of these games. You don't hold back, do you?
No. Well, this is a must-win situation for us, not because there's going to be a great prize with the win, but there's going to be a devastating loss, with the math. Ole Miss is a good team with a bad record. And so, they've lost a few games here in the last possession. So this is a good basketball team that's capable of beating us tonight. But they don't help us much. They can only really hurt us. And so we take it one game at a time. But obviously you're getting close to the end of the season. This team can finish anywhere from, let's say, third all the way to ninth. We've said that for 2 weeks now. This team could be as high as a 5 or 6 seed or not make the tournament based on the end of the season. And so obviously the guys know there's a lot at stake.
Talked in the past about Kermit Davis and his defensive schemes. What are the challenges to facing a Kermit Davis team from your offensive standpoint?
Well, there'll be multiple. I mean, they'll use the 1-3-1. They'll use their man-to-man. They'll trap the ball screen a little bit. They'll double the post. So they do vary. They do change defenses a lot. And Kermit, they're deep. They'll play 3-5 men. They'll play all 9 guys. The kid Brakefield and Morrell are two guys, you can't let beat you. Morrell had 24 the first time, and another guard that scored big against us. We got to do a good job. Our guards have got to do a better job of defending tonight.
Better two than from three, correct?
Better from two than three. They're not a great three-point shooting team. They do a great job of getting it downhill. They do a great job of getting to the foul line. They do a great job in transition, and I hope they continue to struggle from the three tonight.
Talk about the challenge of a team that tries to get downhill as much as Ole Miss, and what is the key defensively to stopping that or controlling that?
Just seeing bodies. You got to sprint back in transition. You got to make sure to see bodies, not wood, eyes in that space. And seeing the ball jump into the ball is really important. Playing strong hands is really important. And then we just got to do a great job in the ball screen offense. And again, Andy, can try to defend without fouling.
Wish all the best tonight. War Eagle.
War Eagle.
Hey, this is head coach Bruce Pearl. Here at Auburn, we revere our traditions. But it's the tradition of hard work that really speaks to me. It's about improving your game every single day and being the best that you can be. In the truck game, Ford has a tradition too, a relentless commitment to building smarter, tougher, and more dependable trucks. That's why I drive Ford F-150, the official truck of the Auburn Tigers. Learn more at buyfordnow.com.
Not all models, trims, or features may be available. Contact your dealer for more information.
Thinking of advancing your career with a master's degree in business? If so, consider the graduate degree choices at Auburn University's Herbert College of Business. Ranked among the nation's best, we offer full-time and online programs in finance, supply chain management, information systems, accounting, and business administration. Learn more at harbert.auburn.edu.
Campbell under center. Campbell's going to throw on the play action into the end zone. Touchdown!
Hi, this is Jason Campbell. The game has changed. The future of Auburn Athletics demands a strong name, image, and likeness collective. That's On to Victory, the NIL collective for Auburn student athletes. I urge you to support On to Victory. You can improve the lives of our players and give our teams the best chance for success. Learn more at ontovictory.com.
Kia of Auburn is happy to connect the Kia brand to the Auburn fans. Our winning lineup has something for everyone at almost any budget. SUVs like the Telluride, Sorento, and Sportage. You prefer a sedan? Check out the Rio, Forte, Soul, or the Sporty Stinger. And don't forget our new multi-purpose vehicles, the Carnival, or our amazing hybrid or electric vehicles. Kia of Auburn is a proud supporter of Auburn Athletics. Kia of Auburn, where you're always number one.
Whoa, Rico.
You're listening to Auburn Basketball. Now more of the CBNS Bank Countdown to Tip-Off.
Jacob Hillman here with you courtside at Neville Arena to remind you the Auburn Tigers put their trust in Auburn AV. Every home game for the best fan experience, and so should you. Bring the basketball game home when you have Auburn AV design and install your home entertainment system, all with frustration-free controls. Visit auburnav.com. Now let's bring in the Hall of Fame coach, Sonny Smith, for his keys to the game. Coach, we talked about it. It is a must-win game for the Auburn Tigers. What are your keys to the game?
I think number one is stay out of foul trouble. They're going to play 11 players, and they're going to be very aggressive. Don't return that aggressiveness as far as fouls concerned. Keep our people in the game. I think that's number one. And number two, do not let them control the tempo with their changing of defenses.
And playing a team for the second time, talk about the mindset and the strategy that goes into that.
Well, they've been taught all week how much this game means. We have. And I think the players have bought into that. They know what this game means. It doesn't mean as much to Ole Miss as it does us. And we got to realize that, and we got to make every adjustment that we need, because they're going to make a lot of changes, and we got to be able to adjust to those changes.
Thank you very much, Coach. We look forward to your call with the voice of the Tigers, Andy Burcham. Coach Sonny Smith's keys to the game are presented by Kia of Auburn, where you're always number one. Straight ahead, we have starting lineups and tip-off of Auburn and Ole Miss at Neville Arena. We take one more break before the Tigers go for the season sweep against the Rebels. This is the Auburn Sports Network.
Hey, Tiger fans. Join Coach Johnny Harris and the Auburn women's basketball staff on the Coach Jay Show. The show airs live on location from Baumhauer's Victory Grill every Monday at 6 p.m. Get the latest updates on the Tigers from Coach Jay while enjoying delicious food from Baumhauer's. The show is available locally on FM Talk 93.9 FM and anywhere else on the Auburn Game Day app. Make your plans now to join us for the Coach Jay Show at Baumhauer's Victory Grill, Mondays at 6. War Eagle!
Hey, Tiger fans, this is Andy Burcham. We need you on February 22nd, Auburn University's Tiger Giving Day. Tiger Giving Day is an annual day of giving where you have an opportunity to pick projects that make a difference in people's lives on campus, in our communities, and across the state. From providing health care in rural areas to making autism services accessible, we've got an exciting lineup of projects that need your help to meet their one-day fundraising goal. So visit tigergiving.org on February 22nd. Pick your projects and give.
Hey, I'm Charles Barkley. Call for a Redmont and water at bars and restaurants throughout the great state of Alabama. Redmont Vodka, available at select ABC stores and package stores. Redmont Vodka is 8 times distilled, gluten-free, and is made from non-GMO corn. Looking to support a local business? Redmont Distilling is Alabama proud and minority-owned. Learn more online at redmontdistilling.com.
CBNS Bank has a long history of stability and a legacy of serving our community's needs for generations. You could say we know a thing or two about tradition. We've been family, community, and financially strong since we began in 1906. Being a team player is part of our culture. That's why at CBNS Bank, we are proud supporters and huge fans of Auburn basketball. Whoa, Regal, hey! Visit cbsbank.com today. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
This is Auburn basketball, and these are the Yellowwood starting lineups for the Tigers.
Drives to the hole, gets a guy in the air, goes up, and makes the shot with a foul on the play. Three ball, Zepp Jasper, yes! Oh, Zepp for three!
Zepp Jasper, senior, Augusta, Georgia, Lucy C. Laney High School.
Went into the hole off the glass, got it at the buzzer! Wendell pops a long three, got it!
Oh. I'm going to get his autograph if he keeps playing like this.
Wendell Green Jr., junior, Detroit, Michigan, Lillamere High School.
19-footer, switch, it was a three! Flanagan, 4-3, bang! Ahead, Flanagan to the hole, with the left-hand hammer!
Allen Flanagan, senior, Little Rock, Arkansas, Parkview High.
Cross court, right wing, Williams, three, got it! It's a steal! Jalen Williams on a breakaway, left-hand hammer! Jalen, another three, got it!
Jalen Williams, senior, Mayhunter, Georgia, Bramley County High School.
Inside the arc, put it up underneath for Broom, to the hole and in! Broom behind the defense, puts it in! Underneath, Broom with a double hand stuff!
Jannot Broom, sophomore, Bland City, Florida, Tampa Catholic.
Introducing the first stain worthy of a yellow tag. From the makers of Yellowwood brand pressure treated pine comes Yellowwood Protector. After all, if it's good enough to earn that little yellow tag, then it's the perfect finish for your five-star backyard.
Auburn is 18-9 overall, 8-6 in the SEC, ranked 30th in the NCAA net, 20 in the KenPom rankings. Bruce Pearl out of Boston College in his ninth season at Auburn, a record of 104 or 184 and 107, and in his 28th season as a head coach, 646, 252 the record. Before the starting lineups for Ole Miss, let's pause 10 seconds for station identification on the Auburn Sports Network. Ole Miss 10-17 overall, 2-12 in the SEC. Kermit Davis out of Mississippi State in his fifth season in Oxford, a record of 74-78, 28th season as a head coach. His record is 543-341. Amari Abram at the point, 6'4 freshman out of Port Arthur, Texas, 8 points, 2.1 rebounds a game. On one wing, Matthew Morrell, a 6'4 junior from Memphis out of IMG Academy. Team leading 14.4 points, 3.6 rebounds, and he leads the Rebels with 2.6 assists. Miles Burns on the other wing, a 6'6 senior from Houston, Texas, a transfer from Loyola New Orleans, 7.4 points, 6.1 rebounds. Jamin Brakefield is really a fourth guard in the lineup tonight for Ole Miss, a 6'8 junior out of Jackson, Mississippi. Auburn scouts him as a guard, not as a forward. He's averaging 10.5 points, 5.6 rebounds. And Robert Allen on the post, a 6'8 senior from Orlando, Florida, Edgewater High School, 4.2 points and 3.2 rebounds per game. Ole Miss 131 in the NCAA net and 121 in the KenPom rankings. Auburn is in the home orange uniforms tonight, tops and bottoms with the blue numerals and lettering and the white trim. And Ole Miss in the away white uniforms tonight with the blue or the red numerals, the blue letters, and the red and blue trim in the lineup. Morrell, Abram, Burns, Brakefield, and Allen for Ole Miss. Green, Jasper, Flanagan, Williams, and Broom for Auburn. Things could be radically different as far as the standings are concerned in the SEC after tonight. That is, with an Auburn win here tonight, and if Auburn can get some help from LSU against Vanderbilt. Well, we'll find out as the evening goes along, as Auburn gets set for Ole Miss. After tonight, the Tigers play at Kentucky on Saturday, at Alabama next Wednesday, and close the regular season here
against Tennessee a week from Saturday. The officials tonight, Bart Lennox, Will Howard, and Courtney Green. Packed house on hand tonight at Neville Arena for this one tonight. We are right in front of the jungle. Literally inches in front of the jungle. Ready for tonight's game between the Tigers and the Rebels. Auburn won in Oxford this year, 82-73. Behind 23 points, 5 rebounds, 7 assists from Wendell Green Jr. Allen Flanagan scored 15 points with 5 rebounds. Jalen Williams had 12 points and 5 assists. And Janai Broome, one of his 8 double-doubles in the SEC, with 19 points and 11 rebounds. Matthew Morrell led Ole Miss with 24 points. Allen in the center circle for Ole Miss, and the tap is controlled by the Rebels. And they'll be going to the basket to our right. Auburn to the basket to our left, and we're underway at Neville Arena.
Auburn Brandman
off the right wing, top to circle, break field. Left wing for Murrell. Murrell, top of the key for Abram, gets a screen. Drives all the way to the basket, lays it in with the left hand.
Now you can expect them attacking the rim because they're going to play with 11 players. They can do anything they want to. They won't get in foul trouble.
2-0 Ole Miss, Auburn's first possession. Left wing, it is Zepp Jasper. Jasper, top of the circle to Green. Wendell picks up the dribble, bounce pass to Flanagan between the rings. Shot clock at 14. Allen on the left hand, throws it into the key for Janai Broome. 9 to shoot. Spins into the lane, turnaround off the glass, good.
They're playing man for man. We're throwing it to the post. They're playing behind the post.
2-2 the score. Ole Miss basketball. Amari Abram off the right wing for Brakefield. Allen to the left wing for Burns. Underneath, shot is up, it's missed. An open layup by Brakefield. Rebounded by Broome. Janai brings it all the way to midcourt. Gets the ball to Wendell Green Jr. down the right side of the lane. Kicks it out to the top of the circle for Allen Flanagan. 18 to shoot. Hands it back to Wendell. Backs up. Hands the ball now Flanagan. Williams right back to Allen on the right wing. Outside the arc. Into the key. At the top, Jalen. Head fake at 3. 7 to shoot to Wendell. On the wing, 5 to shoot. Low post pass. And Auburn gets bailed out on a foul underneath. I think Allen went over the back of Janai Broome on that entry pass.
They don't have great pressure on us. They're just staying between us and the goal. They're closing off the middle so that you don't get the drive as easily, and we'll adjust to that, I think, very quickly.
Shot clock was inside 5 when the foul occurred. Now 20 on the shot clock for Auburn. Inbound Flanagan in the key. 17-footer by Allen. Missed it short. And the rebound comes to Abram for Ole Miss. Up the floor, left-hand dribble. Crossover dribble or behind-the-back dribble. Inside the arc to the top. Burns on the wing right side for Brakefield. Brakefield picked up the dribble. Off the right side for Allen inside the arc. On the right wing for Abram. Three ball in the air. It's missed. Weak side rebound. Ole Miss. Shot is back up and it's good for Miles Burns.
Their wings are going to the offensive boards, which means if we can rebound, we can run on them.
4-2 Ole Miss. Auburn basketball. Jalen from Green to Jasper. Down the left side of the lane, spins, goes up for a shot. Oh, it's in and out. But Zepp was fouled on the play, and he will go to the line for a couple.
Now, you won't see a better move into the lane. A reverse dribble in the middle of the lane, getting a wide open shot. I think we can these people.
The point guard, Abram, picked up the foul, and Zepp Jasper is at the line. 64% from the charity stripe. Zepp just simply hasn't been there very much this season.
No, he moves the ball quickly when it hits his hands. He moves it off the dribble, or he moves it with the pass, and more than likely he's using the pass this year.
First free throw is good for Jasper. He can tie the game here with 17:51 to go in the first half of play, and does with both free throws.
Well, he's been a good free throw shooter throughout his career.
4-4 the score, 17:49 in the first half. Abram, the freshman from Port Arthur, Texas, across midcourt to the right wing for Burns. Burns gets a screen. Off the left wing for Abram. In front of the Auburn bench to Allen, top of the key. Couple dribbles, kicks it on the right side, Murrell. Spins, whistle, foul. It's going to be a foul against Allen Flanagan, I think. He knocked down Allen on the play, and Allen picked up the foul.
Well, that could have gone either way. It was a moving screen. It was also a run over the screen by our defender. So maybe we'll get the next call. They owe us one.
Down the right sideline, Ole Miss will trigger. 20 on the shot clock for the Rebels. We're tied at 4 with 17:33 to go in the first half. Murrell will trigger. To Abram. Picked up by Jasper. Tries to back up Zepp. tries to use the screen. Zepp stays with it. To Allen, top of the key against Broom. Now hands the ball to Brakefield. Picked up by Broom in the switch. Brakefield, free throw line taken away. Lob ahead for Allen Flanagan to the hole. Left hand hammer.
Great defense, a deflection, a great pass ahead by Broom. Our defense is outstanding.
Broom with the assist, Flanagan with the dunk. 6-4 Auburn. 17:04 in the first half of play. Brakefield, right wing, top of the circle, Allen. Left wing, it goes for Miles Burns to Brakefield. Out to the top for Murrell. Gets a screen from Allen. Picked up by Williams in the switch. Right wing, Abram against Jasper. That's a charge.
That's a charge.
Lowered the shoulder and knocked down Zepp.
Andy, everything they're doing now is a ball screen or a screen at the top of the key. And we got to get over those screens or go under them. One way we got to play offense against that.
That is the second foul against Damari Abram, the point guard for Ole Miss.
Well, you can't.
And he will come out now, and Ty Fagan, one of the veterans on this team, a senior from Logtown, Georgia, a transfer from Georgia, is in now at the point replacing Damari Abram.
We're on a different lineup. We're like a 2-3 deep.
Green, bounce pass, Broom, right wing, Williams. Back to Broom, on the perimeter, at the top for Wendell. Picked up the dribble, goes left wing for Zepp Jasper. 17 to shoot, Auburn up 6-4. 16-32 in the first, Zepp to Wendell. Top of the circle for Williams. Now to Allen on the curl. Baseline left, now into the lane. Lost the handle, but was fouled on the play, I think, by Brakefield. I think they'll call that against Brakefield.
Yeah, it looks like we're in a kind of a delay type of passing game, running deep into the shot clock. I don't know if that's by design or Ole Miss's defense is making us do that.
Miles Burns was called for the foul, and Flanagan's at the line to shoot two for Auburn. Allen, senior out of Little Rock, Arkansas, 79% from the stripe. He makes the first free throw.
He's really been playing well lately. Dead ball situations, live ball, defending well.
Just under 11 points, 5 rebounds a game in the SEC, and he knocks home both of the free throws, and Auburn now leads 8-4. 16-22 in the first half. Fagan quickly across midcourt against Zepp Jasper. Couple seniors going at each other right there. Picks up the dribble, free throw line for Murrell. Spins, fade away from 13, in and out. Rebound, Janai.
Give him one shot, and that's what we got to do.
Flanagan up the floor for the Tigers, between the legs dribble. Allen near the point, gets the ball to Wendell Green with 22 to shoot. Under 16 to go in the first half, Auburn 8, Ole Miss 4. Wendell Green Jr. between the rings, gets a screen, goes left wing for Jasper. Zepp to the top, Williams. Now to Flanagan, he had an open three, decided to drive, and was called for a travel on the drive. 15:49 to go in the first half, timeout on the floor. Auburn 8, Ole Miss 4. Stay tuned, Auburn basketball continues in a moment.
This is the moment you've been waiting for.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our home.
When you step onto the court and into the spotlight, the moment to show that hard work and long days pay off. Because when that final shot leaves your hands and we leave our seats, that powerful moment connects us all.
Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
Power for a better Alabama.
Auburn Bank celebrates Hall of Fame coach Sonny Smith as color analyst on the Auburn Sports Network. This is Sonny Says.
Now they all talking over. Let's get another ball. Get one that's square. Something you can't do that. Pardon me. Folks can't see what I'm talking about, though.
No, yeah, this is radio, Sonny. Thank the Lord.
Sonny Says is presented by Auburn Bank, champions of you.
Hello there. My name is Seychelle, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is the punch of flavors that's unlike any other. You get the crispy tenderness of the chicken and that hint of sourness from the pickles. Ta-da!
Hey, I'm Juan, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is you know you're gonna get chicken that's crispy, golden, and juicy. This is the gold standard of chicken sandwiches.
Order the original Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich on the Chick-fil-A app today. Real customers paid for their testimonials.
Follow us on Twitter and Instagram at AU Sports Network.
Now, back to more Auburn basketball.
15:49 to go in the first half at Neville Arena. Auburn 8, Ole Miss 4 in the first half tonight. Presented by Southern Union. Conveniently located just a few miles from Auburn, Southern Union offers classes that easily transfer to the university. Endless opportunities are right up the road. Ole Miss 2 of 5 from the field. Auburn 2 of 3 from the field. And Ole Miss already with their point guard in a little bit of foul trouble. Amari Abel with 2 early fouls here tonight, Sonny.
Well, it's a half-court game. I don't know if we want it to be that way or Ole Miss wants it to be that way. But the tempo of the game needs to change a little bit, and we're the ones going to have to change it.
In what way?
Speed it up.
Okay.
Run with it. Try to get something early, get some early points. Don't let them make it a half-court game running the clock down, and we are also running the clock down on the other end. I think we play better up-tempo. They want it to be down.
Dylan Cardwell checks into the Auburn lineup along with Katie Johnson. Zepp Jasper and Janai Broom on the bench with Wendell Green Jr., Alan Flanagan, Jalen Williams still on the floor for the Tigers. Javius McInnes, a senior at 6'7 from Pearl, Mississippi, into the lineup for Ole Miss. Murrell at the top for Burns. Down the lane, drives on Flanagan, he missed it. And a whistle and a foul, Allen knocked Burns to the floor. That will be the second foul on Allen Flanagan.
They're trying to get into the lane on the dribble. That's what they're trying to do. They're using high ball screens and dribble moves. And we have got to beat that and not let them get the quick shot, make them run the clock down like they're doing it to us.
Leor Berman has tied his career high twice in this SEC schedule against Ole Miss in Missouri. He did it at LSU too, 3 times in the league. With 8 points, he's about to come in for Flanagan, who just picked up his second foul. The free throw from Burns is good, 67% from the line. 418 career steals in his career at Ole Miss and his time at Loyola New Orleans.
I'm concerned about this type of thing. They don't mind the foul trouble because they're going to play 11 or 12 players, and they're going to do that by controlling the ball and trying to guard them off the dribble.
Burns makes both free throws, cuts Auburn's lead to 2 with 15-36 in the first half of play. 8-6 Auburn on top. Wendell Green bounce pass to Dylan Cardwell. Cardwell to Williams, to Wendell on the right wing. 18 to shoot to the top, Jalen Williams. Down the left side of the lane to the hole, off the glass, good!
Doesn't get any better than that. When he's aggressive, he's a heck of a player.
Down the lane, Brakefield kicks it to the corner, 3-ball by Fagan. Didn't get it, weak side rebound, McInnes loses it. Jalen Williams comes out of the crowd for Auburn. Gets the ball right side for Wendell Green. Free throw line, down the left side of the lane. Wendell, jump step, goes up, gets it to Cardwell, he missed it. He missed the second shot, and Ole Miss comes up with a rebound.
Well, we're getting some awful good looks. We gotta knock down some good looks.
Murrell works against Leor Berman in the center circle. Auburn 10, Ole Miss 6. Murrell, right wing, Berman stays with him, gets a screen, picked up by Cardwell. 18-footer in the air switch.
Murrell is a tough out, I can tell you. He can go left, he can go right. He's a pull-up jump shooter, and he's a good defender also.
10-8, Auburn on top of Ole Miss. Green to Cardwell. Off the left side on the wing. Jalen for 3. Nope, missed it long. And the rebound on the weak side to Ty Fagan. Up the floor for the Rebels. They can tie to take the lead. Fagan, left wing, picked up by Cardwell on the sideline. Picks up the dribble. Gets the ball at the top for Murrell. Bounce pass, free throw line, McInnes, picked up by KD. Left wing, Fagan, 3, didn't get it. Rebound, Jalen Williams for Auburn. Outlet Williams, or the Green, left wing KD. Head fake at 3, and Auburn will reset its offense.
We're only given one shot, and that's helping us right now. We got to get some second shots.
Wendell, working at top for Miles Burns. A screen from Cardwell, steps into a 3, in and out. Rebound Brakefield for the Rebels. 10-8, Auburn on top, Ole Miss basketball. Brakefield picks it up, left wing for Murrell. Murrell, top of the key, kicks it into the corner. 3-ball in the air from the corner for Ole Miss. That was in and out for the Rebels.
Push
missed
it
by Burns, rebounded by Cardwell. Green drives all the way to the hole and banked it in.
Yeah, you can beat them because they're trying to slow you down. You need to run, they're calling timeout.
That's the Sun-South drive of the game, Sun-South John Deere. Preferred tractor of the Tigers. Find your local dealer at sunsouth.com. Wendell Green Jr., coast to coast to give Auburn a 12-8 lead. 13:20 to go in the first half. A 30-second to timeout. Auburn on top by 4.
We want to get this tempo changed. They're controlling the tempo right now. We'll get that going, and we did it just then with a fast break layup.
And Wendell Green Jr., buddy, when he got He got that head of steam going.
Oh.
He wasn't going to stop till he got to the rack.
I think we got to attack them. They're attacking us right now. They've made it a half-court game, but I don't think that's going to last because we're only giving them one shot, Andy.
You've talked about Ole Miss's depth. Let's not forget Auburn's depth here tonight as well.
That is a very good point.
It is not. Auburn is not using its depth going as deep as it did early in the season, but it does have nine that it is going to right now.
Yeah.
Broome is into the game. So is Chris Moore for Auburn. Trey Donaldson checks in at the point. So it's Donaldson, KD Johnson, Berman, Moore, and Broome, the Auburn
yeah.
five.
I was concerned that foul trouble would affect us more than it would them. But you're right, our depth is pretty good. It has been good all year.
13:20 to go in the first half. Auburn 12, Ole Miss 8. Rebel basketball following their 20-second or 30-second timeout. T.J. Caldwell now running the point for the Rebels. Off the left wing, picks up the dribble to Murrell, picked up by Berman. Off the right side for Fagan. Low post with a pass, McInnes against Janai. Gets him into the lane, turnaround jumper, he didn't go. Got his own rebound, missed the dunk, got his own rebound again, goes up and draws the foul.
I tell you, we cannot give them second shots. We got to get on that board. And our wing players are looking to run instead of looking to rebound. They got to get in there and not allow them to get second shots.
Chris Moore was called for that foul. Auburn gave McInnes three cracks at that basket, and now he goes to the line to shoot two. He is not a good free throw shooter. 46%, a transfer from Jackson State, where he was a HBCU All-American. First free throw missed.
I always like it when they maintain their reputation, even if it's bad.
Very good defender. Three-time SWAC Defensive Player of the Year at Jackson State. But he missed that first free throw.
Well, he's got some long, lean ability, I can say you that.
He missed the second free throw, and the rebound came to Berman, and now Trey Donaldson up the floor. Auburn has led by as many as four, and that's the Auburn lead here, 12-8. Katie Johnson at the right wing. Gets a screen from Broome. Three ball straight away. Good! Katie Johnson!
He needs to get a shot as quick as he gets in the lineup, and he did so, and he scored so.
15-8 Auburn Tigers by seven. Fagan gets a screen. Ah, around the perimeter, McInnes. Backdoor, Murrell missed the dunk. Holy cow! Berman rebounds. Donaldson ahead for the Tigers. Underneath, Broome to the hole. Yes! With a two-hand hammer. A no-look by Donaldson to Janai.
Great, great pass. You won't see any better than that.
12:19 to go in the first half. A timeout again by Ole Miss. Auburn leads by nine, 17-8. Stay tuned. This is the Auburn Sports Network.
AuburnTigers.com is the official website of Auburn Athletics. Read the latest feature stories on your favorite Tiger teams. Get critical game day info, search videos and audio, find how to get connected through social and digital media, or by joining Tigers Unlimited. Shop the AU Photo Store, or just find the next event on the athletic calendar. Plus, all athletics broadcasts are streamed free at AuburnTigers.com/watch. AuburnTigers.com, the official online home of Auburn Athletics.
This is the moment you've been waiting for.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our home.
When you step onto the court and into the spotlight, the moment to show that hard work and long days pay off. Because when that final shot leaves your hands and we leave our seats, that powerful moment connects us all.
Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
Power for a better Alabama.
We always picture the SEC student athlete for their speed, their vertical, their agility. But it's time we picture them for more. For their campus voice, their community outreach, and for the simple fact that 20 years later, they're still someone's pride and joy. More than students, more than athletes. In the SEC, it just means more.
Jacob Hillman here, courtside with a check of the Yellowwood scoreboard as the Tigers, a no-look pass from Trey Donaldson to Janai Broome, gets the jungle rocking. But this check of the Yellowwood scoreboard brings you LSU defeating Vanderbilt 84-77. What a battle in Baton Rouge. K.J. Williams with 35 points and 10 rebounds. Liam Robbins for Vanderbilt, 23 points, 11 rebounds, and 9 blocks. Another game that went final. Kentucky goes to Florida and wins 82-74. But that LSU win keeps Auburn in the chase above Vanderbilt. Back to the voice of the Tigers, Andy Burcham, and the Hall of Fame coach, Sonny Smith.
That is LSU's first SEC win since opening night in the league when they beat Arkansas in Baton Rouge. They had not won an SEC game since until tonight. It shows you just how tough it is to win on the road in this league. And Auburn goes on the road for two straight games after tonight.
Winners are made on the road in a league as tough as this. That statement means a lot.
Auburn has outscored Ole Miss on fast break 6-0. The bench has outscored Ole Miss 5-0. And the Tigers lead by 9.
When we get it up-tempo, we are the better team.
17-8, Tigers on top, 12-11 in the first. McInnes, right wing, Brakefield. Three ball in the air, it's good.
Brakefield's a very good player. He can score in, he can score out, he can rebound.
6'8 junior out of Jackson, Mississippi with his 29th three ball of the year. That trims Auburn's lead to 6, 17-11. Katie Johnson, two Broom, right side of the lane. At the top, Donaldson. He'll pop a three, didn't get it. Rebound, Moore fights for the rebound and gets it. And it's fouled on the play. Moore got position, pulled the rebound down, and they went over his back.
That's called stealing a rebound. That guy was, they had that rebound, and Moore says, you're not going to get it tonight, brother. I don't know if you said that, but it sounded good.
Yeah, I think he said it, exactly.
I do too.
McInnes called for the foul. Auburn looking for an inbound. Moore to Broom near the right corner. Puts it on the floor with the left hand, drives underneath, goes up, wild shot, banked up, missed it. And the rebound pulled in by Brakefield. Ahead up the left sideline for Caldwell. T.J. Caldwell at the top. Auburn by by six with 11:27 in the first. Caldwell dribbled the ball off his knee and right into the Auburn bench.
We're switching everything, and we're switching it not aggressively and making them do their own turnovers, and it's working out really well. We're not jumping the screen. We're just letting them come over and then picking them up. Switching.
17-11, Auburn on top with the basketball. 11-17 in the first. Donaldson, screen from Broom, gives the ball to Janai. He's open for a three. Oh, missed it. And the rebound pulled in by Brakefield for Ole Miss. He breaks ahead for the Rebels. Drives, puts it up. He didn't get it. Rebound tapped and out of bounds off of Ole Miss, Auburn basketball. Boy, they have missed. Auburn's fortune. They have missed some point-blank shots in this first game.
Yeah, they're getting them because we're not getting back good, number one. We're letting them come off screens, and we're picking them up after they come across. They're getting good shots. Our defense needs to pick up just a little bit, even though we're ahead.
17-11, Auburn, 11 minutes to go in the first half of play. Ole Miss, one of its last seven from the field. K.D. Johnson. Left wing, between the legs dribble, three ball on the wing. That may have been blocked. Rebounded underneath by Berman. To the wing for Johnson. KD drives, goes up for a shot, and draws the foul. KD will go to the free throw line for a couple. The foul will go.
Boy, you could got arrested for that.
Murrell whistled for the foul, yeah.
Woo.
KD will get a couple with 10:47 to go in the first half. Auburn basketball brought to you by Auburn Opelika Tourism. Start your next visit to the Plains at aotourism.com. First free throw missed. Well, that's been a problem for KD. Remember, he was one of four in that two-point loss at Vanderbilt Saturday night.
He has an attitude that he has to score when he gets in there. He's got to get things going his way. And when he does, he's much better. And
second
now
free throw
one, he'll get right now.
18-11, Auburn on top. Ole Miss basketball. Abram loses it, right side, knocked out of bounds by KD. Auburn crowd doesn't agree.
I don't agree either. Of course, I ain't got a call right in the last three games. I've been a good official.
10:41 in the first. Auburn 18-11 with the lead. Abram back into the lineup, remember, with two fouls for the Rebels.
Yes.
Off the left side for Burns. Right side pass. White. Drives on Donaldson. Goes up for a wild shot. Missed it. Got his own rebound. Goes up. Or head fake twice. Underneath Burns. Fadeaway baseline right. Missed it. And McInnes is there for the offensive putback.
We're giving up too many second shots. We're not rebounding as a team. We're rebounding with two guys.
18-13 Auburn. as we approach the midway mark of the first half of play. Donaldson at the point. Screen from Broome. Off the right side. Now Moore. Left wing, KD Johnson. KD tried to pass left side for Moore. It was deflected. And Brakefield comes up with it for Ole Miss. Down the right sideline, Burns runs into Berman. Leor did not have position, and he was called for the foul.
His whistle must have got too dry or something. He's trying to get some wet in it. You didn't need to make that call. It didn't affect anybody.
There was contact, and Leor just did not have position
on
the play. Yep. And it will send Miles Burns to the free throw line, where he is 2 of 2 tonight.
We don't want this game to be played on the free throw line. We don't want this game to be a half-court game. And right now it kind of is that. By both teams, actually.
Burns played at NAIA Loyola New Orleans. He led that program to the NAIA National Championship, where he was a four-time All-American. And he makes the first free throw.
NAIA is a very difficult conference.
He's been a nice addition to this Ole Miss roster this season.
He really has. He leads them in block shots, offensive rebounds. He's a pretty good player.
He makes both free throws, trims Auburn's lead to three with 9:46 in the first.
Well, it's a half-court game, and they're taking advantage of it.
Trey Donaldson picks up the dribble. Right side for Moore. Back to Donaldson. Jalen Williams, Wendell Green in at the next break for Auburn. Donaldson between the legs dribble. Nice move off the left side. Crossover dribble down the lane to the hole. Ball was blocked out of bounds. And Auburn will have it out of bounds, baseline left, with both Wendell Green Jr. and Jalen Williams checking in. Donaldson and Moore sit down, and Auburn will have it out of bounds, baseline left, with six to shoot.
I thought we got fouled on that play pretty bad.
I think Trey Donaldson would agree with you.
They took him out and took him down to the end of the bench to repair his body.
Jalen will trigger baseline left, lobs it, Broome, mid lane, right back to Jalen. Goes up for the dunk and gets fouled by McInnis.
Get up, Jalen. You've never stayed down long.
That's the second foul on Javius McInnis, a transfer out of Jackson State. And Jalen Williams goes to the free throw line for two.
Boy, we've seen some really good passing of the basketball by the Tigers tonight. We haven't got a lot out of it. We got to make a catch and score a basket, then we'll be ready.
Jalen gets a couple. The first is good. Averaging just under three assists a game in Southeastern Conference play.
Well, he's been a solid player all year.
12 points, 3 rebounds, 5 assists in Oxford last month. Knocks home both. 20-15 on him.
He's limping a little bit. I hope he isn't hurt.
Ole Miss basketball. Abram drives on Johnson to the basket. Lobbed it up, missed it. Broome pulls it down with the left hand. Gets the ball ahead. KD Johnson races forward all the way to the hole. Up, he missed it. Rebound Ole Miss. And the Rebels 5-on-4 the other way. Burns drives to the hole, runs into Berman and scores.
Well, I tell you what, both teams running. I can't keep up. My next sip.
Burns leads everyone with 8. Trims Auburn's lead to 3, 20-17. Auburn has not scored a field goal in the last 3:22. KD Johnson at the top. Berman head fake at 3, penetrates into the lane, and a charge on Leor, his second foul of the game. Bruce Pearl not happy with that call.
Well, I'm not either. He probably hadn't called anything in a while. Thought he ought to use his whistle.
Well, here's what Bruce is upset about. The Ole Miss player never had balance. As a matter of fact, he put his shoulder into Leor. There was contact. That's the second foul on Berman. Three ball away from tying it up. Ole Miss basketball. At the top of the circle, Miles Burns. Theo Akuba into the lineup on the low post for the Rebels. Drive to the hole by Brakefield. Kicks it into the right corner. Shot is up and out of bounds. Touch last by KD Johnson off the hand of James White, a sophomore from Conyers, Georgia.
Great defense by KD then, just even to deflect that ball.
8 to shoot for the Rebels down the right sideline. White will trigger. Quick inbound to Murrell. Gets a screen. Picked up by Broome. Right wing, Murrell drives on Janai. goes up and he scores. It's a one-point game and a timeout.
Very difficult to guard Morrell with a post player. He got great quickness with his right or his left hand.
Timeout on the floor. I'm not sure that the clock started. Well, 8:09 to go. We'll figure it out when we come back. 8:09 in the first. They are reviewing the play. Ole Miss. Oh, it was a shot clock violation. I think that's what they're taking a look at right now. As it stands, Auburn is up 20-17. We'll take a break. Auburn basketball continues in a moment.
Thanks for choosing Whataburger. What can I get started for you?
At Whataburger, each meal is made to order, so you can always get exactly what you crave. If that's a Whataburger, what a meal, you got it. But if you're in the mood for something a little more you, like a Whataburger with grilled onions, crispy bacon, and creamy pepper sauce, go for it. March to the beat of your own drum. Bite into the beef of your own Whataburger creation. Whataburger, just like you like it.
We've all fallen into boring routines. We just keep doing what has to get done. Isn't it time to escape the old routine and make time for yourself? Make time to go out with old friends. Make time to add excitement back into your life. Make time to feel like a winner again. Life is more fun when you live it. So what are you waiting for? Escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and WindCreekCasino.com.
The passion, the tradition, the rivalries. SiriusXM is your destination for all things college sports, and we've got your school covered. On SEC Radio, there's complete coverage of every school in the conference, including live games, plus 24/7 talk and analysis. So cheer along online or on the SiriusXM app and listen to your favorite team anywhere. And now, as a college student, you can stream your first 3 months of SiriusXM for $1. Fees and taxes apply. See offer details and subscribe now at SiriusXM.com/SEC Sports.
Follow the Tigers on Twitter at AuburnMBB. Now back to the game.
8:09 in the first half. Auburn 20, Ole Miss 17. There was a shot clock violation called on Ole Miss. They reviewed it, and it stays a shot clock violation. So Auburn has the ball leading by three. If you're searching for that perfect beach home, find your piece of paradise on the Alabama Gulf Coast with the number one REMAX agent in Alabama, Mindy Jones with REMAX Paradise. Begin your search by visiting mindyatparadise.com. Andy Burcham along with Sonny Smith and Jacob Hillman with you. Tomorrow night, Tiger Talk from Baumhauer's Victory Grill. Brad Law rejoins for the Tiger Talk tomorrow night. We'll talk with Auburn Gymnastics coach Jeff Graba. They get set to host Georgia on Friday night. Auburn basketball coach Bruce Pearl and one of Auburn's seniors, Chandler Leopard out of Athens, Alabama, joins us tomorrow night on Tiger Talk.
Andy, they're winning the rebound battle right now, very slightly, but they're doing that. And they got it in the half-court game. That's things that they got going for them. We need to get the game speeded up, and we need to knock down something from the outside.
Auburn basketball, Cardwell back into the lineup for Auburn, along with Zepp Jasper, Wendell Green, right side of the lane. Gets the ball down the lane to Jalen Williams. Try to pass out to the top. It didn't get there. A steal by White drives to the hole. He banked it in.
They're playing solid defense.
Auburn quickly the other way. Green all the way with a reverse layup and scores.
You lay up on me, I'll lay it up on the other end.
Wendell Green coast to coast and gives Auburn a three-point lead. 7:33, first half of play. Ole Miss basketball. Urel. Left wing pass for Miles Burns. At the top, Brakefield. To White on the wing. To Murrell. Curls, drives to the hole, laser jams it with one hand.
We're not protecting the rim right now. They got two rim runs now wide open in the last few times down the court.
22-21 Auburn. We approach the 7 minute mark of the first half. Auburn just one of its last seven from the field. Wendell Green at the top. 19 footer off the left side of the iron. He missed it. Rebound tapped away and out of bounds, and it's Ole Miss basketball.
That was a bad call. That was a bad call.
They say Cardwell knocked the ball out of bounds.
Well, Bruce doesn't think so, and
you're right about that. 22-21, Auburn up by one. Rebels ball. 6:48, first half of play. There's a screen, Murrell off the right wing. Three ball for a two-point lead. Is blocked by Cardwell. Rebounded underneath by Allen, who goes up and draws the foul. That's a Kuba fouled by Jalen Williams.
Physicality right now, I think they got a little bit of a lead on us right now. They're getting some second shots. They're not putting them down, but they're getting them. So that's we got a rebound with five people.
Theo Akuba is originally out of Montgomery. He played at Brubaker Tech, but he played originally at Portland, then at Louisiana. And his free throw is missed. 70 starts while he played at Portland and Louisiana. And while at Louisiana, was the Sun Belt Conference Defensive Player of the Year in 2021.
Oh, by the way, he's still good at it, Andy. Yeah. He's still good at it.
He knocks home the next free throw, and we're tied at 22. Auburn has led by as much as 9. That lead is now 0, tied at 22. Cardwell, left wing, Zepp Jasper. Low post, Jalen Williams didn't get there. It's out of bounds off of Jalen.
Jalen was trying to get into his move before he caught the basketball, and that's not something he will do very often. He's a very solid catcher and shooter.
Fourth turnover against, make that fifth turnover in the first half for Auburn. Rebels with a chance to take the lead. Murrell gets a screen off the right wing, picked up by Cardwell in a switch. Off the left wing it goes. Burns to Murrell, drives. Now back out to the top. Puts it on the floor, drives to the hole off the glass, hole missed by two.
You gotta keep Murrell going to his left. He's terrific going to his right, and he's very, very strong.
He has 6 points. And Ole Miss leads by 4, 24-22. Rebels are 4 of their last 5 from the field. Auburn, 1 of its last 8. Zepp Jasper hands to Wendell Green in front of the Ole Miss bench, up for a 3-point shot, and he's fouled by White. That's a savvy play by Wendell Green.
Yes,
he'll go to the line for 3. The SEC leader with 124 made free throws this season, but of late has not been shooting at the rate that he was a month ago from the free throw line. He'll get 3 here.
I think fatigue is a little bit of that because he plays so many minutes and he plays so hard. And I've noticed that he doesn't bend his knees at times when he shoots shots, but that may not affect him.
First free throw is good by Wendell. Auburn trails by a point with 5:39 to go in the first half of play. Second, money.
Well, we've not been going to the free throw line much, but we're making them pay right now, and
yeah.
I love that.
Auburn 8 of 9 from the line in this first half. Ole Miss is 5 of 8.
Yep.
Wendell can give Auburn the lead with this third free throw.
This is a well-played defensive game by both teams.
And he missed the free throw, missed it short. We're tied at 24, 5:35 in the first half. Rebels ball, Murrell. Cross midcourt, left-hand dribble.
We got to get Murrell out of this game. He can hurt us.
Burns, breakfield, left wing for White. White to Murrell, three ball in the air. Banked up and he missed it. Rebound tap.
Go.
Here's Green on the break with Jalen Williams ahead. Wendell to the hole, reverse layup. Oh, it goes.
You don't get it any better than that.
8. For Wendell Green, and Auburn leads 26-24. Murrell out at the top and fouled by Cardwell.
That'll
get
the
crowd. Dylan reaching in that time, and he picked up the foul.
That play will get the crowd back in the game. I guarantee it got me back in the game.
Wow, what a play by Wendell Green Jr. in traffic, driving to the basket, and then reverse layup as he was flying out of bounds. Cardwell called for a foul. It was all ball on the replay.
And you could see that when it happened. Right in front of the Auburn bench.
One in bonus for Murrell is good.
You got to have nerve to miss one that bad right in front of the opposing team's bench.
Murrell started 24 games last year, second in the SEC at 85% free throws this season.
No, he's got great stats. This kid's a very good player.
And he puts home both free throws. And he will come out now. And Amari Abram is back in for the Rebels.
Well, they got this game in a half-court game. They also are rebounding solidly. Ole Miss is, and that certainly is hurting us a little bit right now.
Tied at 26, Auburn and Ole Miss. Auburn basketball, Flanagan to the hole. Cardwell for the sledgehammer.
That was a screen and roll on the wing, and the big guy rolling to the basket got a great pass from Alan Flanagan.
Good assist by Flanagan. Cardwell finished with authority, and Auburn leads 28-26, 4:40 in the first half of play. Akuba off the left side for Burns. In the lane, White running one-hander. He didn't get it. Rebound, fought for it. It comes to Flanagan.
Look ahead.
Auburn on the break, out and across midcourt. Bounce pass into the corner. Green to Jalen. Ball deflected out to the top for Flanagan. Auburn wanted a foul. Bruce is about to lose his mind on the sideline. Down the lane, Green to the hole. Up and under, didn't get it. Rebound out of bounds off of Cardwell.
The refs must be getting late in the season. The refs are taking the night off in a lot of ways. They're letting a lot go, let's put it that way.
4:10 in the first half. Auburn 28, Ole Miss 26. Abram across midcourt for the Rebels. Picked up by Jasper. Right wing pass for Miles Burns. Back to the top for Abram. Gets a screen. Jasper fights through it. To the wing, right side, Burns. Picked up by Flanagan. At the top, Brakefield. Picked up by Jalen. Picks up the dribble. On the wing, Abram. Down to the baseline. Cut off by Jalen Williams. Shot clock at 3. Shot clock at 2. Underneath, they ran out of time.
Well, they're getting a little more. Moving the basketball, running the clock down.
And a timeout on the floor. 3:41 to go in the first. Auburn ball when we come back. Tigers lead the Rebels 28-26. And this is the Auburn Sports Network.
Live Sports Radio, bringing you inside Neville Arena for all the action of men's and women's basketball game day with no delay. Every dunk, block shot, and steal, plus all the analysis from our Hall of Fame coaches, all with no delay. $25 new or $10 to reprogram the one you already have. Also, use it for every broadcast of home baseball and softball games this spring, all with no delay. With Live Sports Radio, presented by Alpha Insurance.
And we're back with breaking news. Coke Zero Sugar might be the best Coke ever.
That's right, Jim. Coke Zero Sugar is a must-try for any Coke fan, so make sure you... Jim. Jim. We're on the air.
Ooh, yes, this tastes like the best Coke ever to me. Your thoughts, Jen?
Well, can I have a sip?
Jen, we're in the middle of reporting the news.
I need to try it first.
Do you want to know the secret to making a Whataburger? The secret is, there is no secret. It's simple. We make every Whataburger hot, fresh, and made to order with our never-frozen 100% American beef patties, crisp, juicy veggies, fresh toasted buns, and most importantly, we don't start cooking until after you order. Now, if you want to know an actual secret, I put grilled jalapenos on my Whataburger. Whataburger, just like you like it.
Jacob Hillman back courtside at Neville Arena as Auburn leads Ole Miss 28-26 with 3:41 remaining in the first half. We take a check of the Yellowwood scoreboard as top two teams in the nation are in action right now. It's unranked South Carolina taking on number two Alabama. They lead 22-18 with 7:04 to go in the first half. And number one Houston leads Tulane 30-15 with 6:06 to go in the first half. We'll take a full check of the Yellowwood scoreboard, including all the SEC scores and top 25 action during the Connecticut Sausage Halftime Report. But for the final 3:41 of the first half, Andy Burcham and Sonny Smith.
28-26, Auburn on top. Sonny, you've talked about how Auburn needs to get this game in an upward motion.
Yes.
Fast break points right now, clearly in favor of Auburn, 10-4.
Well, we got to keep doing that. Offensively, our half-court game is playing them basically even, and it's going to come down to who's rebounding the best. And right now, I haven't looked down closely, but I think it's probably fairly even.
Flanagan, right side, Williams, back to Allen. Bounce pass to the low post for Janai. Double-teamed into the corner. Wendell, head fake at 3 to the wing. Jalen for 3. Yes.
Ball movement is everything to the Tigers.
That's beautiful that time.
Oh, ball movement.
Crisp even.
Crisp.
31-26 Auburn.
Krispy Kreme is a donut.
Morrell off the right side. Nearly lost it to Jasper. Right wing pass. It comes to Abram now.
He walked about 8 feet.
14 to shoot. Drives to the basket. Kicks it into the corner, but it's kicked literally by Alan Flanagan, and that'll bring Chris Moore, KD Johnson in. Jasper will sit down. So does Jasper and Chris hasn't come into the ballgame yet.
Coming
now
back.
He is. He'll replace Flanagan. Okay.
Well, they got it in a half-court game, and they're staying right in it. Ole Miss, I'm speaking of.
Right.
But we've got a couple of fast breaks. One thing you look for is a three-point shot, and nobody's making them.
Inbound underneath shot is up and a foul on Chris Moore. They got the ball to Theo Akuba, and the call was a foul on Chris.
I've seen
his
bumps.
Second. And Akuba back at the line for two for Ole Miss.
I've seen bumps in a supermarket harder than that. Gee whiz. He must have got tired of loafing and started making a call.
Moore is going to come right back out of the ballgame after this first free throw by Theo Akuba. And the free throw is missed. Auburn basketball brought to you in part by Ford. Check out the Ford F-150 at your local Ford dealer. F-150, official truck of the Auburn Tigers.
He doesn't shoot well from here, and I hope he keeps his reputation intact.
Second free throw from Akuba is good.
Nah, I should have kept my mouth shut.
I'm not going to say a word to that.
Don't.
Okay. 2:54 in the first. Auburn 31, Ole Miss 27. Green, left wing Flanagan, low post Broom, turnaround jumper, good!
Oh, what a beautiful play, and what a beautiful design play as well.
A decisive turnaround jumper by Janai Broom, and Auburn leads 33-27. Right wing break field for the Rebels. At the top of Akuba to Murrell, left wing. Top of the circle for White, penetrates to the hole. Goes up and he scores.
I tell you, they're taking our guards to the market now, and we got to do a better job of keeping that drive out of the middle of the lane.
33-29 Auburn, 2:16 in the first half. Wendell between the circles. To Jalen Williams. Left wing for Broom. Janai head fake at three. Now backs his man down to the lane. Spins on Akuba. Gets cut off. Kicks it into the corner. Wendell. Flanagan to the basket. To the left wing. Jalen for three. Yes!
Whoopee!
Came with three on the shot clock.
What a play.
150 in this first half. 36-29 Auburn. Auburn now 3 of 8 from the three-point stripe. Murrell works at the top against Wendell Green. Drives on Wendell down to the basket. And he's stripped out of there by Wendell. Auburn races the other way. Wendell leaves for Broom. Down the lane. Up with the left hand. Yes!
Boy, great. You get running on these folks. They're in trouble.
8 points for Broom. 38-29 Auburn. Matches the Tigers' largest lead of the half. A minute 19 in the first half of play. Rebels ball. Murrell between the circles. Hands the ball right side for Burns. Burns drives on Flanagan to the hole. He lays it up and in.
Oh, that's a great play. We're trying to take a charge instead of defend the goal. We got to defend the rim better.
1 minute to go in the first. Auburn 38, Ole Miss 31. Tiger basketball, Green, Broom out at the top. Janai, one dribble, now to Williams. Three ball, Jalen didn't get it. And Akuba gets the rebound for Ole Miss.
A little bit quick, but Jalen, anytime he shoots, I think it's going in, though.
Rebels ball. Auburn by 7. 41 seconds in the first half of play. Off the left side, Burns. Top of the circle, break field. Right wing, White. Working on KD. White brings it out to the top. Goes off the right side, or off the left side. Dribbles the ball almost to midcourt. Picks it up. Now to Burns. Three ball in the air. He didn't get it. Rebound Burns. Auburn didn't take care of the ball. Rebels ball at the top, White. 13 seconds in the first. Down the baseline, shot is up. It's good by Burns.
We're looking at our man more than we are when we're away from the ball.
Wendell Green races forward, gets fouled with 4.5 seconds to go in the half. And Wendell will go to the line for a one and bonus. The foul was called against Murrell. That's his second. And Wendell Green Jr. will get a one in bonus here. Boy, it was like a pinball racing up court for the Tigers.
We've had a lot of pinball play here tonight. They're letting them play.
That they are. 9 fouls in the first half for Ole Miss, 8 for Auburn. Auburn 9 of 11 from the line. Ole Miss 8 of 12.
That was putting it nice when we said they're letting them play.
McInnes out. And Allen back in. And now Wendell Green at the line for a one and bonus for Auburn. 4.5 seconds to go in the first half. Auburn 38, Ole Miss 33. First free throw is good.
Now we got 4 seconds. We don't want to foul these people in this 4 second thing. You got to know they're going to get it down fast and get it up quick, but don't foul them.
6, make that 9 points in the first half for Wendell. 4.5 seconds to go in the half. Second free throw coming for the junior out of Detroit, Michigan. He got it. Rebels
them.
Ball full length of the floor to go.
We're hurting them from the free throw line.
White will trigger. Gets it inbound, right back to White on the give and go.
Don't foul.
Across midcourt, left wing, 3-ball, good if it goes, it's no good. And the first half comes to a close. At the break, Auburn leads by 7. Auburn led by as many as 9 in the first half of play. Auburn trailed by a point at Ole Miss back in January. Pulled away for an 82-73 win. What's coming up in the second half tonight with Auburn on top, 40-33. Take a look around the Southeastern Conference and also what's going on in the Auburn campus and around the Auburn campus. Time now for the Konecka Sausage Halftime Report. And here is Jacob Hillman.
Thank you, Andy. A strong finish for the Tigers in the first half, making 4 of their last 5 field goals to take that 7-point lead into the break. This is the Konecka Sausage Halftime Show. The Konecka Sausage Company is proud to be the official smoked sausage and hot dog of the Auburn Tigers. Make Konecka Sausage part of your game day and family traditions. Well, like Andy said, it's action-packed across the SEC and college basketball. Let's go through some SEC scores to start things off as we take a look at the Yellowwood scoreboard, a full check of the Yellowwood scoreboard. LSU takes down Vanderbilt 84-77 in Baton Rouge. K.J. Williams, 35 points and 10 rebounds. And Liam Robbins had 23 points, 11 rebounds, and 9 blocks for Vanderbilt, but it's not enough. And that's a big game for Auburn as the Tigers and Vanderbilt were tied in the SEC standings, and the Commodores had the tiebreaker. So a win tonight would put Auburn ahead of Vanderbilt in the SEC standings. Kentucky goes to Gainesville, defeats Florida 82-74. In action now, South Carolina leads number 2 Alabama 29-25 with 3:32 to go in the first half. G.G. Jackson has 13 points to lead the Gamecocks. Now we go to top 25 action. A big upset at Boston College as the Eagles take down number 6 Virginia 63-48. It was the lowest scoring output from Virginia so far this season. And then a dominating performance from the UConn Huskies, 87-69 over number 20 Providence. Adam Sanogo, he has 16 points and 3 blocks to lead the Huskies. And number 1, Houston is in action tonight as well, hosting Tulane. The Cougars lead the Green Wave 38-24 with 2:25 to go in the first half. It's an action-packed week on the plains as well. It's underway with crossover season in full swing. We will tell you all about it and more when we take a look around Auburn Athletics. This is the Auburn Sports Network.
From Auburn to Corvallis to Omaha, the Tigers are going to the College World Series.
February 17th, the Tigers return to the Diamond.
Here comes Ware. He makes the catch going to his knees.
Bases clearing double by Cole Foster.
This is your home for Auburn baseball.
That one sails into the night and over the wall.
He struck him out swinging. A complete game victory for Joseph Gonzalez.
The Auburn Sports Network.
Southern homes are particularly vulnerable to termites. In this climate, you need guaranteed protection. You need Cook's Pest Control and Centricon. Termites attack the Centricon stations, exposing themselves to an agent that eliminates their entire colony. Upgrade from old-fashioned liquid service to the proven protection of Centricon and Cook's Pest Control. Call Cook's today for a free evaluation.
In 1925, Modelo began brewing beer for those who believe in better. A model beer, steeped in the tradition of tireless effort. A rich, Pilsner-style lager for those who wear their heart and heritage in their rolled-up sleeve. Since our first batch to every bottle raised today, we've proved that it doesn't matter where you come from, it matters what you're made of. Modelo Especial, brewed for those with a fighting spirit. Drink responsibly. Beer imported by Crown Imports, Chicago, Illinois.
We've all been caught up in the little chores that pile up every day. The dishes in the sink, the trash that needs taking out, the pesky check engine light. Isn't it time to make a change and escape to a whole new world of possibilities? Where there's dinner without dishes, nights filled with adventure, and every day you feel like a winner. A little change can go a long way when you escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and WindCreekCasino.com.
Welcome back to the Konecka Sausage Halftime Show, where Auburn leads Ole Miss 40-33 at the break inside Neville Arena. Jacob Hillman here with you courtside at Neville Arena. Let's take a look around Auburn Athletics this week, and we just saw the 2023 football signing class announced and introduced to the Auburn family here at halftime at Neville Arena. Coach Hugh Freeze with a stellar signing class in the short time that he had to do that. But we'll start with some action that took place earlier this evening with number 20 Auburn softball taking down UAB 10-1 at J&B Moore Field. It was a perfect game for Maddie Penta and Shelby Lowe for 3 2/3. But the Blazers were able to put a couple of base runners on and score a run. Bree Ellis, Annabelle Weitra, and Isis Trestvik all homered to keep up the strong offensive stretch for Auburn. The Tigers will host the Plainsman Invite Friday through Sunday with the likes of Merrimack, Brown, and North Dakota State coming to town. Britt Bowen and J.J. Jackson will have the call throughout the weekend. Women's basketball hits the road for the final time tomorrow night when it faces Georgia at 6 Central. There's still a chance at postseason play past the SEC tournament in Greenville if Auburn can get its overall record north of 500. Tomorrow's coverage can be heard in the Auburn area on FM Talk 93.9 and anywhere on the Auburn Tigers app beginning at 5:45 with big-time Britt Bowen on the call. Indoor track and field gets its postseason underway at SEC Championships on Friday in Fayetteville, Arkansas. Head coach Leroy Burrell has high expectations for his high jumpers, his sprinters, and throwers over the weekend as the Tigers look to build some momentum going into NCAA's and outdoor season. Men's tennis heads down I-85 South on Friday and Saturday for the Blue-Gray Classic and one more non-conference showdown before SEC play begins. Anyone in the Montgomery area that wants to attend this tournament, they can do it for free at Lagoon Park and the O'Connor Tennis Center. So those in the Montgomery area, go support the Auburn Tigers. Number 7 gymnastics returns to Neville Arena on Friday at 6:30 Central to host number 14 Georgia. Like all the meets this season, it is sold out. So if you have tickets and are unable to attend Friday evening, be sure to transfer them to family or friends at aubtix.com. Resell through StubHub, the official ticketing partner of Auburn Athletics, or donate back to the Auburn Athletics Department. Maybe we'll find a good home for those tickets. Doors will open at 5 Central for Friday's meet, so arrive early. There's only two more chances to see the likes of Suni Lee and Darion Goburn inside Neville Arena. And it's a surprise baseball series at Plainsman Park as weather in Los Angeles has forced the series with USC to be moved to Auburn this weekend. The Tigers will host the Trojans on Friday at 6 Central, Saturday at 2, and Sunday at noon. Brad Law will have the call all weekend long at Plainsman Park, starting 15 minutes before first pitch of each game. For those interested in attending, the remaining ticket inventory will go on sale tomorrow at aubtix.com at 10 a.m. Central. Should be perfect weather this weekend for two quality baseball programs to square off. Trojans coming to Plainsman Park for the first time ever. The next men's basketball broadcast will be on Saturday as Auburn heads to Rupp Arena looking for its first win at Kentucky since 1988. Tip-off is set for 3 Central. Andy Burcham, Joe Champion, and myself will have the call beginning at 2:30. Again, your score at the half, Auburn 40, Ole Miss 33. We take a look at the first half stats when the Konecka Sausage Halftime Show continues in a moment.
Kaneka Sausage is a product we all know and love, and it's the official sausage and hot dog of the Auburn Tigers. Kaneka Sausage is made from the finest cuts of pork, patented blend of seasonings, all natural casings, and smoked over a pure hickory fire for that true southern flavor. Enjoy a crowd-pleasing Kaneka Sausage dog or premium hot dog while watching the Tigers, and make Kaneka part of your game day or any day. Kaneka Sausage is celebrating their 75th year of the Sessions family, making their premium smoked sausage in Evergreen, Alabama. Be sure to visit the new Kaneka gift shop right off I-65 at exit 96.
In 1925, Modelo began brewing beer for those who believe in better. A model beer, steeped in the tradition of tireless effort. A rich, Pilsner-style lager for those who wear their heart and heritage in their rolled-up sleeve. Since our first batch to every bottle raised today, we've proved that it doesn't matter where you come from. It matters what you're made of. Modelo Especial, brewed for those with a fighting spirit. Drink responsibly. Beer imported by Crown Imports, Chicago, Illinois.
In SEC sports, the ifs come at you every minute. What if your QB had released the ball a second earlier? What if the head coach hadn't used his last timeout? What if your team goes all the way this season? If you love the tradition, if you live for the rivalry, if you can't wait each week for the absolute edge of your seat action, Regions is right there with you as the official bank of the SEC.
Regions can't help you with the ifs in sports. Regions helps you embrace the fan life.
Member FDIC.
This is Auburn head coach and proud Ford F-150 owner, Bruce Pearl. The thing I hear most when people get in the cab of my F-150 is, this truck is huge. Well, I drive around some pretty big players, and when I get a 7-footer in the back seat and he's able to spread out, he's just blown away at how roomy and comfortable this truck is. So visit your local Ford dealer and check out Ford F-150, the official truck of the Auburn Tigers.
Not all models, trims, or features may be available. Contact your dealer for more information.
Backdoor Murrell missed the dunk. Holy cow. Berman rebounds. Donaldson ahead for the Tigers. Underneath Broom to the hole. Yes, but the two-hand hammer. A no-look by Donaldson to Janai.
Beautiful no-look pass from Trey Donaldson to find Janai Broom for the easy two-handed dunk. And Janai had 8 total points in that first half, but it was Jalen Williams and Wendell Green Jr. leading the way in scoring. And now we take a look at the first half numbers, and we remind you that the halftime numbers are brought to you by the Alabama Department of Public Health. Don't wait, vaccinate. Protect yourself and others against COVID and flu. Visit alabamapublichealth.gov/IMM. Now as we take a look at some of the team stats, Coach Sonny Smith talked about trying to speed the game up, and that's what the Tigers did, leading Ole Miss in fast break points 12-4. Auburn turned it over 9 times. Ole Miss turned it over 8 times. So a good job by the Tigers to turn those turnovers into points. Inside the paint, Ole Miss led the way with 20 points to Auburn's 16. Second chance points, the Rebels had it again, 7 to Auburn's 3. And off the bench, 8 points for Ole Miss to Auburn's 6. Looking at the rebound numbers, Ole Miss led the way with 19. Auburn had 14. And then assist-wise, Auburn had 8 assists in that first half. Ole Miss only had 3, so a good job by the Tigers to pass the ball around. In the first half, Auburn shot 48.1%. Ole Miss only 41.4%. And the Tigers hit 3 threes on 9 attempts, and Ole Miss hit 1 on 8 attempts. Leading scorer for the Rebels, Miles Burns. He had 12 points in the first half. Also had 2 rebounds. And it was Matthew Morrell following him up with 8 points, and he had 1 turnover. For the Tigers, like I mentioned, Wendell Green, Jalen Williams with 10 points apiece. Wendell had 1 rebound, but he had 2 assists, and Jalen had a rebound. Janai Broom with 3 rebounds along with his 8 points. And those are your halftime stats, and once again, your score at halftime, Auburn 40, Ole Miss 33. We will have second half action from Neville Arena between Auburn and Ole Miss with the voice of the Tigers, Andy Burcham, and the Hall of Fame coach, Sonny Smith, after this.
You've been listening to the Kaneka Sausage Halftime Show. Make Kaneka Sausage part of your game day. Still family owned and made in Evergreen, Alabama since 1947. The second half is 2 minutes away. This is the Auburn Sports Network.
Hey, Tiger fans. Join Coach Johnny Harris and the Auburn women's basketball staff for the Coach Jay Show. The show airs live on location from Baumhauer's Victory Grill every Monday at 6 p.m. Get the latest updates on the Tigers from Coach Jay while enjoying delicious food from Baumhauer's. The show is available locally on FM Talk 93.9 FM and anywhere else on the Auburn Game Day app. Make your plans now to join us for the Coach Jay Show at Baumhauer's Victory Grill. Mondays at 6. War Eagle.
Kaneka Sausage is a product we all know and love, and it's the official sausage and hot dog of the Auburn Tigers. Kaneka Sausage is made from the finest cuts of pork, patented blend of seasonings, all-natural casings, and smoked over a pure hickory fire for that true southern flavor. Enjoy a crowd-pleasing Kaneka Sausage dog or premium hot dog while watching the Tigers and make Kaneka part of your game day or any day. Kaneka Sausage is celebrating their 75th year of the Sessions family, making their premium smoked sausage in Evergreen, Alabama. Be sure to visit the new Kaneka gift shop right off I-65 at exit 96.
North American beavers are excellent swimmers, but on land, they waddle about clumsily. That is until they spot the yellow tag on a stack of Yellowwood brand pressure-treated pine. Their instincts kick in, and the colony springs into action. Just like that, these master builders make off with their newfound building materials.
For five-star backyards, Yellowwood brand pressure-treated pine. If it doesn't have that yellow tag, you don't want it.
It's a great day for Auburn Tigers to get vaccinated. COVID and flu vaccines are an important tool to help stop the pandemic. The Alabama Department of Public Health is offering the COVID and flu vaccines to anyone 6 months and older. COVID and flu. The COVID and flu vaccines are safe, effective, and free. COVID and flu are still on the rise. Don't let COVID and flu stop you from supporting your favorite team. Continue to help protect yourself, your friends, and our campus by getting the COVID and flu vaccines. For more information, visit alabamapublichealth.gov/IMM.
The Second Half Spark is brought to you by the finest electricians in the world, the brothers and sisters of the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local 613.
Auburn by 7 going into the second half. Let me take a stab at the Second Half Spark tonight. Get out and run in the second half tonight, Sonny's
man. We don't want this to be a half-court game. They're staying even with us and slightly ahead in big points.
Auburn was outscored in the paint by Ole Miss in the first half, 20-16, but outscored the Rebels in transition, 12-4 in the first half.
You could know it before the game. You could not let this be a half-court game. They're a bunch of 6'5 athletes, what they are. They can get into the lane, they can create a lot of, but we're not letting them shoot any threes, and that's good.
Auburn will have the ball to open the second half of play. Jalen Williams with 10 points, along with Wendell Green Jr.'s 10, leading the Tigers. It's the second straight game. This stat coming from Marlene DeVore, Auburn's fine sports information director for basketball. Second straight game that Jalen has scored double figures by halftime. And he had 12 points in the game along with 5 assists at Ole Miss last month.
If we're going to win this game, our perimeter people got a rebound because their perimeter people are dogging that board. They may not be getting the ball, but they're keeping it alive.
Auburn's out-rebounded 19-14 in the first half. Auburn ball to open the second. Flanagan at the wing, top of the circle for Broom. Left-handed pass, left side for Wendell. Top of the circle, Jalen. Off the left side for Wendell with 14 to shoot. Wendell, top of the key, hands the ball there to Allen Flanagan. Now to Zepp Jasper, 8 to shoot. Zepp, step back 3, didn't get it. And the rebound to Burns for the Rebels.
Woo-hoo. Almost had a steal.
Wendell almost got a steal on Burns. Rebels down 7 with the basketball. Abram between the circles. Picked up 2 quick fouls in the first half. Down the lane, Murrell off the glass. Nobody's fouled in the play. He acted a little bit, but Jalen Williams called for the foul, his second in the game. And Murrell, one of the best free throw shooters, not only in the SEC, but the country, is at the line for 2 more.
We got to know that everything they're trying to do is to get into the lane on a dribble. They're not throwing very many passes in there, but they're trying to get in on the dribble and get to the free throw line or make something cheap.
Murrell 2 of 2 tonight from the free throw line. And his first free throw is missed. An 85% free throw shooter. When he misses, that's news.
Well, that's true. You know what? He has all league potential. He has had that every year.
A junior from Memphis, and he makes the second free throw.
All right, we cannot be putting them on a free throw line. We got to get there ourselves.
40-34 Auburn, 19-13 in the second half of play. Auburn basketball. Wendell to Flanagan. Off the left side, dumps to Broom. Janai, left side, Zepp, 3. Yes.
Great passing, but Janai Broom out of the post, to the wing for a wide open three.
19 threes on the air for Zepp Jasper. And Auburn leads by 9, 43-34, 18:51 to go in the second half. Abram between the rings. Working on Jasper. Picks it up, throws top of the circle for Brakewell. On the wing for Burns. To the top for Allen. Allen, left wing for Murrell. Down to the free throw line. Allen drives to the hole, gets blocked by Flanagan, gets it back and misses it. The rebound out of bounds. They never got rim, and Auburn gets it on a shot clock violation.
I've seen horses that didn't get rode as hard as these guys are on our back. These refs got a call out every once in a while.
Flanagan blocked the dunk attempt by Allen, and they're going to make sure that the ball did not hit the rim in any of the attempts by Ole Miss. Flanagan blocked the shot. He got it back to Allen, missed the second shot, did not draw iron.
Yeah.
They never did draw iron.
Well, all I was watching was how much they're jumping on the back. They got to separate that from the game. When you're not a great high-leaping, tall team, you can jump on the back, but if it's not called, you're going to ride high.
It is Auburn basketball and the shot clock violation against the Rebels.
Well, I'm glad you caught that. I can't hardly tell time, much less clock time. I didn't mean to say that.
That's
for
quite.
All you people that thought I could.
I know they're disappointed.
Yeah, but they're.
43-34 Auburn. The lead has never gone to double figures for the Tigers, although Auburn's flirted with it.
Ole Miss, you got to give them credit. They're playing great defense. They're keeping our guards out of the lane. We need to get in there.
Broom at the top. Picked up by Allen to Flanagan on the curl. At the top, Allen working on Burns. Three ball, right side of the field. Good. From a
great
from
play
Allen
by Allen Flanagan, playing outstanding basketball last game.
And Auburn goes up 12, 46-34, 18 minutes to go. In the second half, Auburn's hit back-to-back threes. Jasper and Flanagan. And Auburn leads it 46-34, Rebels ball. Allen, one dribble to Abram, working on Broom. Thought about driving, thought better of it. 10 to shoot. Abram, step back three for the Rebels. Good.
Oh, my goodness.
His 29th three of the year.
Yeah, and he's hit 33% from threes. That's not bad.
46-37 Auburn. 17:30 to go in the second half. Wendell backs up into the center circle. There's the screen from Williams. Gets the ball to Jalen. Left side. Broom for three. Yes!
You know what? He's getting more confident facing the goal when he gets outside.
11 in the game for Jani Broom, and Auburn back up by 12. Three threes in a row for Auburn in the second half. 17:08, and Jani out way out on top. Fouls Allen, and he knew it.
That's
first
what you
foul
call
on Jani.
Foolish. That was a foolish
now,
foul.
He knew it as soon as he did it. You do that in the lane, you might get away with it.
Oh,
you do
yeah.
that 10 feet on top of the key. That's never going to, you'll never get away with that.
With these three guys, you can get away with murder every once in a while.
17:08 in the second, Auburn by 12.
I shouldn't have said that.
49-37 Tigers. Abram, right side, Burns, top of the key, Brakefield. Left wing now for Murrell. Murrell to the top for Abram, picked up by Allen Flanagan. Gets a screen, picked up by Broom in the switch. Five to shoot. Abram, step back, 18-footer, nope, short. Long rebound though, Murrell. He'll pop a three.
You.
Got it.
Murrell and a step in three can really hit the bucket.
Auburn by nine again, 49-40. 16:36 in the second half of play. Been trading three-pointers here in the second half. Each team has three.
Both teams still playing man.
Oh, bad pass. Burns steals it and goes in for a two-handed dunk.
Well, their defensive pressure is trying to push you out away from the three-point line. And they're doing a good job of that, and they also get a turnover there.
Sixth turnover by Auburn. The Rebels have cut the lead to seven. And Wendell driving to the basket, fouled by Murrell off the left side.
That's
the third foul in Matthew Murrell.
When you're looking for people that you say hard to guard, I think you could put Wendell Green in that area.
Without question.
He's difficult to guard on the dribble as anybody I know of in the conference.
I think it's one of the reasons that he's been to the free throw line as many times as
he has
this season.
Sure, he's hard to guard.
Down the left side, on the left sideline, Auburn ball. 49-42, the inbound to Wendell. Oh, he tried to throw to Flanagan, who didn't see the pass coming. Burns with another steal. to the hole, and he's fouled by Wendell Green.
That was a very bad pass. They were trying to run a play, but Wendell saw a wide-open guy, but he cut right before that and left us with a bad turnover.
Back-to-back turnovers for Wendell Green. Boy, you just don't see that very often.
No. Well, that was because he's trying to run a play that was called, but the player that made the cut did not see it.
Miles Burns leads everyone with 14 points in the contest, and he's at the line for two, where he is 4 of 4 tonight. 49-42 Tigers.
You got to keep him off the board. You got to keep him off the free throw line. He's really good on the things that he does.
And he missed the free throw.
Yeah, I said that because he's only shooting 66%. I thought if I said something good, he'd miss it.
You were right.
That was tricky. Got to be tricky.
He has 2 steals tonight. He has over 420 steals in his college career.
I watch him on defense. He's all over his guy like a blanket.
He missed both free throws. Flanagan gets the rebound. Under 16 minutes to go.
All right.
Second half.
Get our half-court offense going because they're making it a half-court game.
49-42 Auburn. Allen Flanagan between the rings. Screen from Broom. Gets a step. Dumps it. Broom dunks it.
What a play. Pick and roll out high. Allen Flanagan made a great, great pass.
13 for Janai. 51-42 Auburn. 15-34, second half of play. Abram being guarded loosely by Jasper. Abram to the sideline. Brakefield picks up the dribble. McKinnis, right side of the key. To Abram, inside the key. Drives on Broom, stays right with him. Knocks the ball away to McKinney. McKinnis up for a shot, it was blocked. Rebounded by Green, the block by Broom, and Wendell knocked to the floor by Burns, who helps him up. And that takes us to our first media timeout of the second half. 15:08 to go, second half. Auburn 51, Ole Miss 42. Stay tuned, Auburn basketball continues in a moment.
Hey, I'm Charles Barkley. Call for a Redmont and water at bars and restaurants throughout the great state of Alabama. Redmont Vodka, available at select ABC stores and package stores. Redmond Vodka is 8 times distilled, gluten-free, and is made from non-GMO corn. Looking to support a local business? Redmond Distilling is Alabama proud and minority-owned. Learn more online at redmonddistilling.com.
I love working on my cars, but I wish I had more space for my shop.
Give General Steel a call. In business for over 30 years and with over 5,000 five-star customer reviews, General Steel can help with projects ranging from RV storage and garages to churches, workshops, and even major construction for Fortune 500 companies. And all General Steel custom buildings are backed by our 50-year warranty.
But that's got to cost a fortune.
Actually, General Steel buildings are more affordable than other building options. And thanks to our highly efficient construction, you can go from dreaming it to enjoying it in no time.
I need to give the General a call. How do I get more information?
Call 866-96-STEEL or visit mygeneralsteel.com to find out what General Steel can do for your home or business. That's 866-96-STEEL. Our team will answer your questions and offer you a customized quote. Just call 866-967-8335 now or mygeneralsteel.com.
Auburn basketball is brought to you by Alabama Power. At Alabama Power, we give 100% to achieve 99.9% dependability. Our commitment helps deliver power for a better Alabama.
15:08 to go in the second half. Auburn 51, Ole Miss 42. Auburn ball coming out of the immediate timeout with 28 to shoot. Auburn basketball brought to you by East Alabama Health. With more than 70 new physicians added in the past 4 years, they're growing their healthcare team to meet the growing needs of Auburn, Opelika, and the surrounding area. 8-time Hall of Fame coach Sonny Smith and Jacob Hillman alongside. We'll be back at Tiger Talk tomorrow night starting at 6 o'clock from Baumhauer's Victory Grill. Of course, brought to you by Alpha Insurance. Auburn gymnastics coach Jeff Graba, Auburn basketball coach Bruce Pearl, and Auburn basketball senior Chandler Leopard on the show tomorrow night.
You know, this has been a very physical game. The refs are letting them play, and both teams have been handing it out.
Auburn has been out-rebounded tonight, 22-16. That includes 10 on the offensive glass. Now, this It's an Ole Miss team that averages 12 offensive rebounds a game.
Our perimeter players got a rebound and block out a little bit.
Flanagan straight away, three, no. Rebound, Cardwell knocks it out of bounds. At least he got a hand on it.
Yeah, you're going to get a great effort out of him every night. Every night.
Dylan Cardwell, Jalen Williams, Allen Flanagan, KD Johnson, Trey Donaldson from 5-1 in the Auburn lineup right now.
Well, it's still a half-court game. We don't want it to be that way.
Brakefield, low post. McInnis up, and he was fouled from behind by Dylan Cardwell. And McInnis will go to the line for a couple. Second foul on Cap.
Well,
he, along with Leor Berman this week, Sonny, named academic all-district team.
Oh, my goodness.
Something you and I would have no idea of.
Well, I don't want to brag, but I was
voted. I know you don't. McInnis' free throw is missed. Go ahead. I'm sorry. I cut you off.
No, I can't top that.
You didn't have anything to follow that up, did you?
No.
You knew I was going to say something.
You got me good. You should give me a chance before you cut me up.
All right, you're right. I apologize. McInnis' second free throw is good.
Oh, my goodness. 50% is still I don't like the way they're creeping back in now. We got to get something going. This game is too much half court.
51-43, Auburn. Donaldson drives right side of the key. Pulls it back out with the left hand. Sets the offense in motion, 18 to shoot. Donaldson, right wing Flanagan. Allen looking underneath. Out of the top for Donaldson. Penetrates, 15-footer Trey. It's good.
Oh. I love that Vegas shot. That Vegas shot.
It danced on the iron and fell through.
Yeah.
Auburn by 10, 53-43. Rebels ball. Abram at the right sideline. Picks up the dribble. Centers it to Brakefield between the rings. Right back to Abram. 19 to shoot for the Rebels. Abram back to the left side for Brakefield. Penetrates down to the baseline. Cut off by Jalen. Bumps him a couple times. Right hand shot. Good.
That's a tremendous move. Well defended, by the way.
First two-point field goal of the night for April, or for Brakefield. Back to an eight-point Auburn lead. 13-47 in the second half.
It's still a half-court game, and I don't like that.
Donaldson dumps it underneath, and Jalen had it stripped. Steal by Murrell. Up to the right wing. Brakefield drives to the hole. Up and under. Cardwell, he missed it. Rebounded by Flanagan. Races ahead for Auburn. Allen goes to the hole. Coast to coast with the left-hand hammer.
I love it when they're on a run. Let those horses run.
55-45 Auburn. 13-18 in the second half of play. Abram, right sideline, Brakefield. McInnis between the circles. Left wing for Burns. Low post Brakefield against Jalen. Tries to back him into the lane. Knocks down Jalen and scores.
Well, they're letting him play.
13 minutes in the second half. Auburn can't shake the Rebels. Auburn leads it by 8. Donaldson, KD Johnson at the top, off the left side, inside the arc, free throw line, down to the basket, goes down and gets fouled, and goes down in a heap. I think it's on the drive, not the shot. The foul is against Abram. It is his third, and it was on the drive.
Yeah.
Brakefield comes out, so does Abram for Ole Miss. Allen and White are back in for the Rebels.
I say it a lot, and I'm right a lot. We're really good on out-of-bounds plays.
Out-of-bounds baseline right. Auburn flattens it up to the baseline. Inbound Flanagan out to the wing. Donaldson at the top. Cardwell. Donaldson with 16 to shoot. Flanagan gets a screen. Inside the arc. 18-footer. It's short. Rebound Burns for the Rebels. Auburn by 8. Ole Miss ball. Burns tried to drive. He was cut off. Now to Murrell. Three ball straight away. Good.
I tell you what, Burns and Murrell can really hurt you. If you're going to switch on them, you got to pressure them up and keep them from driving.
55-50, Auburn on top. Murrell with 15 points to lead everybody. Cardwell, low post, KD, kicks it into the corner right side. Now brings it to the wing. KD between the legs, dribbled about 8 times. Drives, pull up, 18-footer, no. Long rebound comes to Murrell. Up the floor for Ole Miss. Across midcourt, Murrell penetrates to the basket. Whistle and a foul.
By who?
Foul's going to go, I think, against Jalen. They will shoot free throws when we come back. It wasn't on Jalen because he's on the floor. He's on the bench.
Yeah. They're winning the half-court battle right now. It may not show up in points, but they're getting in the lane on dribbles. They're getting wide-open shots. We got to get this out of a half-court game, get it up-tempo.
Foul was against Trey Donaldson, his first. 11:54 in the second. Auburn 55, Ole Miss 50. This is the Auburn Sports Network.
Download the Auburn Game Day app. Find tickets, skip concession lines, be a part of game day giveaways. Shop the latest Auburn gear. Stay current with a comprehensive social media stream. Participate in game day light shows. Plus, listen to every Auburn Sports Network broadcast, even when multiple games are happening simultaneously. On the official mobile app of Auburn Athletics, the Auburn Game Day app. Get it today.
Are you looking to advance your career without putting your life on hold? Consider the flexibility of an online MBA at Auburn University's Harvard College of Business. Ranked among the nation's best by U.S. News & World Report, our 100% online MBA program provides the flexibility you need to pursue a degree while maintaining your personal and professional life. Learn more at harvard.auburn.edu.
When you see the SEC student athlete, it's easy to picture the swing, the stance, the form. But look closer, and you'll see the heart, the brain, the clutch lab partner, the avid two-stepper, the pride of a hometown, and a little brother's hero. More than students, more than athletes. In the SEC, it just means more.
Welcome back to Neville Arena, where Auburn leads Ole Miss 55-50 with 11:54 to go in this ball game. We take a check at the Yellowwood scoreboard as number 2 Alabama has taken the lead at South Carolina 41-40 with 15:47 to go there, and number 1 Houston continues to lead Tulane 53-31 with 15:23 to go. Back to Andy Burcham and Sonny Smith.
Auburn's lead is 5. Ole Miss at the free throw line coming out of the timeout break. Ole Miss has out-rebounded Auburn 26-17. That includes 11 offensive rebounds by the Rebels. And they have outscored Auburn on second chance points tonight, 10-3.
Yeah, when you get this in a half-court game, with the size of their players compared to our perimeter players, they get an edge occasionally. Yeah.
Auburn's much bigger on the interior.
Yeah.
On the exterior, on the perimeter, though, Ole Miss is a bigger
team.
Ball club.
We're a small team.
Murrell at the line for 2. He cut the lead to 3 here.
Murrell and Burns are hurting us. They're not the only ones, but they're major players.
He makes the first free throw. By the way, Leor Berman and Wendell Green Jr. in the lineup now for Auburn. 55-51 Auburn. Murrell can cut the lead to 3. Auburn is led by as much as 12. Murrell cuts the lead to 3.
All right, we got to get a good shot. Don't throw the ball away now. Run your offense.
Morrell, 6 points in the second half alone. Auburn ball, Chris Moore. 2, Wendell Green Jr. in the center circle. 18 to shoot. Right wing, Leor Berman. At the top, Broom. Left side, KD. Back to Broom, left side of the lane. Spins, gets double teamed. Up, no. Rebound, Ole Miss.
They're giving us one shot, and it's not a good shot right now. It's their defense.
3 ball away from tying it. Murrell to the right sideline. Hands the ball there to Miles Burns. Left wing, Murrell. 3 ball in the air for the tie. He missed it. Auburn fortunate. The rebound deflects off of Wendell Green Jr. Out of bounds. Ole Miss ball. 11-11 in the first or the second half. Auburn's lead at 3. Rebel ball. 20 to shoot.
Yeah. Our perimeter players got a rebound, block out and rebound, or chase and a rebound, either one.
Burns will trigger down the left sideline. A second crack to cut the lead under 3 here.
Yeah, Murrell and Burns got to be guarded.
Right sideline, White to Murrell between the rings. Left wing to Burns, to Murrell at the top. Lobs it, alley-oop, McInnes grabs, shoots, scores.
Now, we were in a kind of a zone then. I don't know if it was called or it appeared to be a zone. They went behind the zone, got an offensive pass and rebound.
9-0 run by Ole Miss. Trims the lead to 155-54. Ole Miss or Auburn on offense. KD, top of the circle for Moore. Hands back to Wendell. 13 to shoot for Auburn. By one, Wendell penetrates. 18-foot fadeaway. No. Rebound. KD Johnson runs it down. Throws it into the backcourt. White runs it down for the Rebels. Drives, gets the ball to Allen off the glass. Ole Miss leads.
Ole Miss is just out hustling us right now. Their perimeter people are whipping our perimeter people.
Ole Miss on an 11-0 run has taken the lead. 10 minutes and 8 seconds in the second half. Ole Miss 56, Auburn 55. Berman, low post, Broom, turnaround jumper, didn't get it. Rebound Rebels, White on a breakout. To the hole, White scores, Ole Miss by 3.
They're beating us down the floor. We're taking one shot, getting no second shots, and they're hurting us right now.
13-0 run by Ole Miss. Auburn across midcourt calls timeout. Ole Miss by 3. 58-55. 9:44 to go in the second half. Timeout on the floor. Stay tuned. Auburn basketball continues in a moment.
And we're back with breaking news. Coke Zero Sugar might be the best Coke ever.
That's right, Jim. Coke Zero Sugar is a must-try for any Coke fan, so make sure you... Jim. Jim. We're on the air.
Ooh, yes, this tastes like the best Coke ever to me. Your thoughts, Jen?
Well, can I have a sip?
Jen, we're in the middle of reporting the news.
I need to try it first.
Southern homes are particularly vulnerable to termites. In this climate, you need guaranteed protection. You need Cook's Pest Control and Centricon. Termites attack the Centricon stations, exposing themselves to an agent that eliminates their entire colony. Upgrade from old-fashioned liquid service to the proven protection of Centricon and Cook's Pest Control. Call Cook's today for a free evaluation.
Looky, 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 here comes Cookie, Cook's Pest Control.
What widens the eyes, tightens the stomach, and flutters the heart? Adrenaline. Feel it for yourself in the Toyota RAV4, Camry, Corolla, and Tacoma. Lease a new 2023 Toyota RAV4 LE for $309 a month for 36 months. Toyota, let's go places. Offer valid through February 28, 2023. Well-qualified lessees with approved credit through Southeast Toyota Finance. 3608 due at signing. No security deposit. With select equipment, $350 disposition fee. Excludes tax, tag, registration, title, and dealer fee. See dealer for details.
Auburn basketball is brought to you by Chick-fil-A. All Chick-fil-A locations in Alabama proudly support the Auburn Tigers.
Auburn has gone 3 minutes and 44 seconds without scoring. The Tigers have missed their last five shots. In the meantime, Ole Miss has gone on a 13-0 run. They've hit their last three shots. And with 9:44 to go in the second half, Ole Miss leads Auburn 58-55. No one gets you closer to college basketball than SiriusXM. Download the SiriusXM app. Take your Auburn Tigers with you all season long. Tune into SiriusXM SEC Radio for news, talk, analysis, and more straight from your phone. No car required.
Well, one thing's got to happen right now is we're only getting one shot. And all the time, it's not a real good shot. We got to take good shots, get second shots, and we got to defend that rim a little better because they're driving in and getting what they want.
Heard Bruce Pearl talk about it in the pregame. A loss tonight would be catastrophic for Auburn. To this Ole Miss team with three games remaining in the SEC, at Kentucky, at Alabama, and at home against Tennessee.
Our perimeter people got to become productive.
Broom off the inbound to Flanagan. Auburn down three, and Flanagan's ball is stolen. Ole Miss with a steal, White with the ball for the Rebels. Across midcourt against KD Johnson. Now to Murrell between the circles. 58-55 Ole Miss, 9:25 in the second. Burns, right wing. Down to the low post, McKinnis blocked from behind by Broom and rebounded by Flanagan. Allen up the floor, low post for Janai in the lane, bumped. Wild shot goes up and he draws the foul. Janai will go to the line for a couple.
Well, if we can get it in there, he can make something happen because they can't guard him. And they're trying to keep him out of the post area by biting up on him and pushing him. But he's working a lot harder to get the ball now.
Kermit Davis saying, hey, listen, you call that at their end of the floor. You got to call my guy getting blocked at my end of the floor. McInnis called for the foul. Broom at the line for two. First free throw is good for Janai. His first free throw of the night. And Auburn stops a 13-0 run. Still doesn't have a field goal. The last 4:18. Janai makes both.
All right. Now, we'll probably press a little bit. Token press. No, we're not doing it.
Urell up the floor. Auburn fans respond. Tigers trail by one. 58-57. 9 minutes to go, second half. Murrell on the right wing, picked up by Broom and a switch. Allen off the wing. Murrell step back, now into the arc, down the lane. Wild shot up and a foul. And the foul will go against Wendell Green Jr., his second. And it will send Murrell to the line to shoot two, where he is 5 of 6 tonight.
Well, their game right now is to get into the lane on the dribble after a ball screen, or just beating their guy one-on-one straight up.
Matthew Murrell on the evening, 17 points, 2 rebounds, and 1 assist.
Well, there's no question he's one of the better players in the league. He's been that way for a number of years.
He makes the first free throw. Gives Ole Miss a 2-point lead with 8:52 to go in the second half.
Well, I didn't want this to be a half-court game, and it's turned out that it probably has. But you got to give Ole Miss a lot of credit. They're preventing us from running with the ball.
Murrell makes both free throws. It's back to a 3-point game. 60-57 Ole Miss. 8:52 to go in the second half. Wendell Green between the circles. It's Jalen Williams. Left sideline, KD. KD on the wing, penetrates, drives on Murrell, puts it up. It was blocked. Rebounded by the Rebels. Burns up the floor for Ole Miss. Crossover dribble. Drives to the hole, put it up, blocked by Broom, out of bounds. Auburn now with 10 turnovers on the night.
Broom protecting that rim pretty good right now. They're coming in there and he's knocking everything down, and I believe it might have bounced off their leg.
8:32 to go in the second half. Rebels ball out of bounds, baseline left, Murrell will trigger.
We've been defending out-of-bounds plays. Let's keep that up. They're going to go try to go one-on-one on you.
White, the inbound burns at the top. Murrell, 17 to shoot. Ole Miss by three, 8:24 and a counting clock. Second half in Neville Arena. Left side burns. Top of the circle, Allen. Right wing, White, 6 to shoot. White penetrates, 17-footer. He didn't get it. Rebound, KD Johnson. On the break for Auburn. KD, left wing, drives into the key and throws it away. Allen with the steal. McInnis throws it out of bounds for Ole Miss. Auburn fortunate there.
KD trying to make too many plays right now. He's got 4 other guys he could go to out there.
Bruce Pearl trying to settle his troops down. That's 11 turnovers for Auburn tonight.
Yeah, we're not taking care of the basketball. Our perimeter players are not playing their normal game.
8 minutes to go. Auburn trails by 3 at home against the Rebels. Green lobs it, low post, Williams to the hole with a two-hand dunk.
That was a call play from the bench. And when we got the team on our side where the bench is, we get a lot better call.
12 minutes deep in the second half, Jalen Williams, who was double figures in the first half, gets his first bucket of the second. Allen, White, left side, Ole Miss by 1. Murrell at the top, foul by Ole Miss. I think Allen will get called. Nope, it's McInnis called for the foul.
Well, this game
that's
is very
his fourth, physical. And a timeout on the floor. 7:34 to go, second half. Auburn ball trailing Ole Miss 60-59. Stay tuned. Auburn basketball continues in a moment.
Tiger Talk has been Auburn's weekly coaches show for over 30 years. Join Bruce Pearl and other Auburn coaches every Thursday night at 6 Central. Send questions by tweeting at AU Sports Network or by emailing aubtigertalk@gmail.com. Tiger Talk is presented by Alpha Insurance. Don't miss Tiger Talk, Thursdays at 6 Central, only on the Auburn Sports Network.
This just in. Auburn Bank has completed their 114th year of serving their community.
This next one goes out to Auburn Bank, champions of you.
Touchdown! touchdown, Auburn Bank. The champions of you are 114-0.
Welcome to Auburn Bank. How can we help?
I hear y'all are undefeated.
Helping you achieve your financial goals is our goal. Visit championsofyou.com to see how we can serve you. Auburn Bank, champions of you. Member FDIC.
We always picture the SEC student athlete for their speed, their vertical, their agility. But it's time we picture them for more. For their campus voice, their community outreach, and for the simple fact that 20 years later, they're still someone's pride and joy. More than students, more than athletes. In the SEC, it just means more.
Jacob Hillman back courtside at Neville Arena as we take a look at the Yellowwood scoreboard. It's South Carolina back on top, hosting number 2 Alabama, 47-44. They're at the under 12, 11:28 to go in Columbia. Back to Andy Burcham and Sonny Smith.
Second half tonight presented by Wind Creek Hotel and Casino, with 3 Alabama locations in Atmore, Montgomery, and Wetumpka. You escape every day at Wind Creek Hotel and Casino and online at windcreek.com. Auburn trails by a point, 7:34 to go in the second half. Auburn has been out-rebounded, 31-19 tonight, Sonny Smith.
Yeah, the perimeter people are dominating our perimeter people. In fact, the rebounds that they're getting.
But Auburn has the ball coming out of this timeout break, trailing by one.
We're only down one.
Exactly. Auburn went 4.5 minutes without a field goal, and Ole Miss used that to go on a 13-0 run to take the lead. Auburn is led by as many as 12 in this second half. Ole Miss is led by as many as 3. Currently, Ole Miss by 1, Auburn ball. Williams on the left wing. Hits Broom on the perimeter. Back out to the top for Wendell. Wendell Green, left sideline for KD with a screen from Broom. Double teamed, tries to get out of that double team. Underneath, intended for Jalen. It didn't get there. Burns with a steal to White, left sideline, drives, stripped. And here's Auburn the other way. Wendell is fouled. Wendell stripped White, who went to the basket, and then Wendell was fouled, and that should put Auburn at the free throw line. That should give Auburn the bonus. Or was that just the sixth foul? Just the sixth. Excuse me. The foul was whistled against Robert Allen, his second.
Well, what they're doing right now is they're picking us up higher and trying to keep us out of the lane by pushing us out. We got to get into that lane on a dribble or a pass.
Flanagan, Williams back to Allen with a screen from Broom. Right side at the top, Jalen. To Flanagan between the rings, 17 to shoot. Allen, a 3 for the lead, short. Rebound Rebels, White with the rebound.
We're only getting one shot, and those shots that we're taking are not good shots.
Ole Miss by 1, 6:42 to go, second half. Rebels basketball. Murrell to the top. Brakefield to Murrell with a screen. Picked up by Wendell Green. Lost it, got it back to Brakefield between the circles. Kicks it on the wing. Burns guarded by Flanagan. Low post now. Allen outside the lane. Allen left wing, White. Wide open 3 ball. He got it. Ole Miss by 4.
Well, we were helping in the wrong areas, and that was a mistake.
Ole Miss by 4, 63-59, 6:10 in the second half of play. Auburn just one of its last 7 from the field. Wendell Green drives down the lane to the basket, up with the right hand. It's good and a foul on the play.
Well, there's not a better player in the league at making a play when you've got to have a play. And the kid is just terrific at that.
Wendell with a chance for the and one, his first field goal, his first points of the second half, Wendell Green Jr. The foul was whistled against Jamin Brakefield, his first. And Wendell is at the line with a chance to cut the lead back to 1 with 6:02 to go in the second half.
Well, they've kept us out of the lane on the dribble and the pass. And when we get in there like we just did with Wendell Green, we can make hay.
3-point play is good for Wendell. Back to a 1-point game. Zepp Jasper into the lineup for Auburn, replacing KD Johnson. Between the circles, Zepp picked up by Matthew Murrell. Murrell, left-hand dribble at the top, it's Brakefield. Back to Murrell, drives to the hole, he laid it up, he missed it. Rebound to Flanagan. Ahead, Wendell Green. A chance for Auburn to take the lead. Wendell at the free throw line. To the top, Jalen, three, no. Rebound, Jani Broom in the lane. Wrap around underneath, Wendell scores!
Great passing, great rebounding by Jani.
The high-low from Jani to the littlest guy on the floor, and Auburn takes the lead. 64-63.
Right, gotta have a stop.
Timeout, Ole Miss. 5:18 to go in the second half. A 30-second timeout, so we'll keep it here.
Well, we started making plays by getting the ball into the lane on the dribble and by attacking the board and giving us a chance at second shots. If we can do those things the rest of this way, keep them out of the middle, we'll be okay.
Tomorrow night, Tiger Talk at Baumhauer's Victory Grill, brought to you by Alpha Insurance. Yours truly, Brad Law, Jacob Hillman, joined by Auburn Gymnastics Coach Jeff Graba, Auburn Men's Basketball Head Coach Bruce Pearl, and Auburn Senior Chandler Leppard. Don't forget Friday, softball against Merrimack and Brown at J.B. Moore Field. Baseball here against USC. They've moved that series here. Brad Law with the call along with Paul Ellen. Friday evening at 5:45 from Plainsman Park. 2 o'clock Saturday and then noon on Sunday. I guess this was a full timeout.
Or else
we'll keep it here during the timeout.
They might have taken a 30, I'm not sure.
Well, they called a 30 and then...
Okay, they made it into
And they have made it into a full timeout. 5 minutes, 18 seconds to go in the second half. Jani Broom to Wendell Green. High-low from Green, from Broom to Green. What an oddity that is. The 6'10 guy finds the 5'11 guy for the layup in the lane.
Yeah, and it doesn't matter with us if we can get the ball into the middle of that lane somehow. On the dribble, on the pass, we can either put it in or kick it out and get something good. You know, the one thing about this game, nothing has changed. And nothing. Both teams played man-to-man all the time. Both teams attacked the middle of the lane all the time. It's been a heck of a game.
Auburn looks for a stop with its starting five. Wendell Green Jr., Zepp Jasper, Alan Flanagan, Jalen Williams, Jani Broom. For Ole Miss, James White, Javius McKinnis, Jamin Brakefield, Matthew Morrell, and Miles Burns. And it's Murrell with the ball. Off the left side, Brakefield. To Murrell, whistle, or rather McKinnis, a whistle and a foul underneath. And now they're going to the free throw line on a foul away
what
from the ball.
That?
I don't know. I think it's going to go against Zepp Jasper.
I don't know what it's about.
It is Zepp's first.
It'd have to be just a touch foul.
And James White, a 50% free throw shooter, who has scored 9 points tonight, goes to the stripe for a one and bonus. First free throw is good. And we're tied again. 5-12 in the second half. White ties the game at 64.
We got a block out. He's not a good free throw shooter, so we don't want that ball to be rebounded.
He missed the second. The rebound comes to Broom. Tied at 64, Auburn ball. 5:07, second half of play.
Yeah, we don't want any bad shots. We want to get it in that lane on the dribble or the pass.
Wendell Green Jr. drives inside the arc, steps back, back again. Off the glass, high, missed it. Rebound, Williams. Ball knocked out of his hand. It's out of bounds to Auburn with 11 to shoot for the Tigers.
Well, actually, that was a foul, but at least we got the ball back.
This game has featured 6 ties and 5 lead changes.
Yeah, and it's been a half-court game. We did not want it to be a half-court game, but you've got to give Ole Miss credit. They made it a half-court game.
4:52 in the second, 11 on the shot clock. Auburn, Broom, inbound to 2, Green. Now to Flanagan, 7 to shoot. Allen up from about 7, banked up, missed it. Rebound, Broom put it up. It's good. They're going to call basket interference. And Broom is credited with the basket, and Auburn leads by 2. 4:44 to go in the second half of play.
They're tapping Allen Flanagan on the elbow every time, and they're getting away with it.
17 points and 6 rebounds for Jani. He had a double-double in Oxford, 19 and 11. Auburn by 2, 4:40 to go.
We need a big-time stop right here.
66-64 Tigers. Murrell across midcourt to the left wing for White. Picked up by Jasper to Murrell. Penetrates down the lane to the hole. He banked up. He missed it. Rebound. That's got to be Auburn ball, and it is.
That's a foul.
It should have been a foul. You're right. It should have been a foul on Brakefield. But Auburn gets the ball, leading by two, with 4:27 to go in the second half. Auburn fortunate. Morrell got a step to the basket.
Now, we do not need a – we need to get a good look this time.
Wendell Green Jr. across midcourt, top of the circle. High post pass, Broom. 17-footer. Yes!
I tell you what.
Good enough.
They're going to find out. You can make fool with him. He can face up as well as play with his back to the basket.
68-64 Auburn, 4:03 in the second half of play. Rebels basketball, Murrell center circle. Gets a screen. Drives right wing. Picked up by Broom in the switch. Murrell backs up. Right wing, step back, head fake at three. To White, right wing, nine to shoot. White, 17-footer, no. Rebound underneath Flanagan. Auburn on the break, Wendell Green ahead. Wendell drives to the hole, reverse layup, got it! Woo-hoo! Auburn by six!
What a play!
70-64, Wendell Green with the reverse layup.
That would be a SportsCenter play in Roan Mountain, I guarantee it would.
70-64, Auburn. 3:21 in the second half. White, right wing for the Rebels. Out to the top, Murrell. Left wing, Brakefield to the hole. Drives, he missed it and he was fouled. I think Jalen got him. Yep, or the foul goes against Jalen Williams, and it takes us to our final media timeout. Auburn 70, Ole Miss 64. 3:14 to go in the second half. Stay tuned, Auburn basketball continues in a moment.
This is the moment you've been waiting for.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our home.
When you step onto the court and into the spotlight, the moment to show that hard work and long days pay off. Because when that final shot leaves your hands and we leave our seats, that powerful moment connects us all.
Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
Power for a better Alabama.
Hey, Tiger fans, this is Andy Bertram. We need you on February 22nd, Auburn University's Tiger Giving Day. Tiger Giving Day is an annual day of giving where you have an opportunity to pick projects that make a difference in people's lives on campus, in our communities, and across the state. From providing health care in rural areas to making autism services accessible, we've got an exciting lineup of projects that need your help to meet their one-day fundraising goal. So visit tigergiving.org on February 22nd. Pick your projects and give.
Most creatures blend in with their natural surroundings. However, one North American beaver colony is doing anything but. This group, having discovered new Yellowwood Protector semi-transparent stain and water repellent, has coated their lodge in a lovely smoky gray color. Modern look and powerful protection, backed by the yellow tag. Well done.
Introducing the first stain worthy of the yellow tag, Yellowwood Protector semi-transparent stain and water repellent. Find a dealer near you.
A look at the defensive statistics is brought to you by Cook's Pest Control and Centricon. You don't have to live with termites.
Now, the one defensive statistic does not look good for Auburn, despite the fact that Auburn leads by by six with 3:14 in the second half. Auburn has been out-rebounded tonight, 32-26, giving up 13 offensive rebounds. But Auburn leads it 70-64. For every Auburn three-pointer, Berkshire Hathaway Home Services donates $25 to Coach Pearl's Outlive Cancer Initiative, benefiting local cancer patients and treatment centers. Six threes for Auburn tonight. Rebels shooting free throws coming out of the timeout break. 3:14 to go. Auburn 70, Ole Miss 64.
Well, we could change this rebound thing if our perimeter players will become rebound conscious on every play down the floor. Then I think we can take care of them. Their perimeter players are probably the ones burning us on the board.
Jamin Brakefield steps to the charity stripe for Ole Miss. Junior out of Jackson, Mississippi, and Huntington Prep. 10.5 points, 5.6 rebounds, scored 12 first time around against Auburn. He's a transfer from Duke.
Duke.
A 67% free throw shooter. Had four threes earlier this year at Tennessee. And these are two huge free throws for Ole Miss, trailing by six with 3:14 to go in the second half.
If this Ole Miss team was in other leagues, they would be in the top half.
Brakefield's free throw is good.
They made the mistake of being in the SEC, and that makes it a little tough.
3:14 in the second. Auburn 70, Ole Miss 65. Brakefield can cut it to four. 3-14 in the second half. And he made both.
All right, got to have a bucket or go to the free throw line. We got to go, nothing empty coming down.
Rebels 17 of 26 from the line, Auburn 14 of 16. Auburn ball leading by four. Wendell Green, crossover dribble, right side of the lane, picks it up. Now out to Flanagan, 16 to shoot. Allen on the right hand, dribble to the right wing. Gets a screen, nope, goes underneath the broom, 9 to shoot. Janai, turnaround jumper off the glass, it didn't go.
Got it, needed that one.
Rebound to Murrell. Auburn's lead is 4, Ole Miss ball. 2:42 in the second half, Murrell. Right sideline for Brakefield, to the top for Allen. Off the wing, Brakefield, penetrates. Gets it back to the top, White, left wing, Burns. At the top, it's Brakefield to Murrell on the wing, to the free throw line. Runs into Broom, and a whistle and a foul against Jasper. We'll put them at the line for a one and bonus.
That's a guy that passed up a bank robbery trying to find a murder. And they foul first, and he just ignored it. Oh, my
God. Brakefield back at the stripe. This is a one and bonus. 2:28 to go. It's a four-point Auburn lead. Second foul on Zepp Jasper.
That was a bad call. A very bad call.
Murrell gets a one and bonus. Outstanding free throw shooter. Got it. Three-point Auburn lead.
He is very good there.
They have not scored a field goal in their last 3:53. But they can cut the lead to two right here with 2:28 to go.
Got to block out now. One time we didn't block out, they got the ball back.
Oh, they were in the lane early. A lane violation on Brakefield, and Murrell knocked it home. Woo-hoo. It stays a three-point Auburn lead.
I love a good official.
Whoa. Let's see if that's a huge break for Auburn.
That's going to be a huge. If we take care of the basketball, get it in that lane somehow, we're going to get a basketball.
Auburn 70, Ole Miss 67, 2:20 in the second half. At the top, Williams from Green. Right back to Wendell, 19 to shoot. Right side, Zepp. Top of the circle, hands it back to Wendell. Penetrates, free throw line. Kicks it left side, Flanagan.
Count
three,
it.
Short. Rebound, Ole Miss. And Murrell will bring it up the floor. They're a three ball away from tying it. 2 minutes to go.
Got a good shot, didn't make it.
70 to 67 Auburn. Ole Miss ball trails by three. Murrell working on Wendell Green straight away. Gets a screen, passes it underneath, and Auburn kicked it. That's right, that's correct. The ball was kicked by Auburn at the top of the key. It all looked like Auburn was gonna get the ball, but it was deflected by Auburn.
Was it an intentional kick?
It was kicked. No, it wasn't intentional, but it was off the leg of Wendell Green.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Auburn would like them to take a look at the replay. They will not be granted that. Ole Miss ball. 20 on the shot clock, Rebels. At the time, Murrell. Now guarded by Zepp. Gets a screen. Left side picked up by Zepp at the top. Three ball, Allen to tie it. He missed it. They didn't want that guy shooting. He's only 1 of 9 from three.
Oh, I liked it.
And Auburn gets the ball back. 1:30 to go, leading by three. Wendell Green across midcourt. Hands the ball to Flanagan, drives off the left wing. Allen faces the basket to the hole, up and nobody was fouled. He'll go to the line for two.
Allen Flanagan is a very aggressive offensive player. When he's got things going, he puts the other team in a bind.
Race week for the second annual War Eagle Fest is straight away. Go to WarEagleRunFest.com to sign up and finish on the 50. Allen Flanagan at the line, two enormous free throws for Auburn.
We got to have dead ball points now. We got to have them because they got to get a little desperate here in the 120s.
Two free throws, Allen. The first is good. Flanagan on the night. 10 points, 6 rebounds, 5 assists. For Flanagan. Auburn leads it by 4. He can make it 5 with 1:20 to go. Second free throw. Yes.
All right, don't foul him. No foul.
1:20 to go. Auburn's lead is 5. 72-67, Auburn. They come to their feet at Neville Arena. Murrell across midcourt works on Jasper. Straight away to Allen. Picks it up to Burns. Burns now between the circles. Picked up by Green. Left-hand dribble off the left wing. Picked up by Janai, and a switch. He drives to the hole. Janai blocked it. Rebounded Ole Miss. Shot clock at 7. Timeout, Ole Miss.
They must have teed up the coach. Only thing that could have happened.
They called a timeout. It's a timeout with 7 on the shot clock. And Kermit Davis getting on the officials. They've heard it from both of the coaches tonight.
Well, I think Kermit might have had a little he might have had a little to grab about right there.
Kermit, I think, wants the shot clock to reset.
Yes.
But I don't think they ever got rim. 7 to shoot for Ole Miss. 56.3 seconds to go. Auburn 72, Ole Miss 67. Rebels will have the ball down the right sideline. Trailing Auburn by 5. Boy, one more stop for Auburn. Woo! Allen Flanagan, 2 huge free throws. Last time down the floor for Auburn.
All right, now what? Where is the ball being taken out?
I think it's on the sideline, Sonny.
I think it should be.
That's where they were when they called the timeout.
That's what I think. We want it on the sideline. They got to start to play out at midcourt.
They will trigger about midway down the right sideline, and it will come from James White in front of the Ole Miss bench.
Now, one thing about it, we got a rebound with 5 when that ball goes up.
Inbound to Murrell. To Brakefield, goes down, loses it to Murrell at the top, launches a 3. He missed it. Rebound, Rebels fouled by Broome.
Well, this is a one play we cannot allow a second shot in. A bad shot from midcourt.
Murrell's shot did draw iron. That's why the shot clock reset. And then Allen got the rebound and was fouled by Janai. No question about that. And Allen goes to the line for 2. They're in the double bonus.
And he's not a great free throw shooter.
65% the first. He missed it.
Now, you got to block out this time because he may miss another one. I feel a miss coming on.
46.8 seconds to go. Allen made the second free throw.
All right.
They will press. 72-68 Auburn. White shadows Wendell Green across midcourt. 39 seconds to go. 20 on the shot clock, Auburn. 72-68 Auburn. Wendell Green at midcourt. Working there against James White. Fouled him. And Wendell will go to the charity stripe for Auburn.
All right.
That will put him at the line for a 1 and bonus. Second foul on White.
Make the free throws.
Yeah.
Guard and do not foul and give them only 1 shot.
30 3/10 seconds to go in the second half. Auburn 72, Ole Miss 68. And Wendell Green Jr. at the line, a 1 and bonus. He can make it a full 2 possession game with these free throws. First, nothing but nylon.
Nothing but nylon.
Second could give Auburn a 6-point lead with 30 3/10 seconds remaining.
All right, look for a second shot on a miss. If you don't miss it, get back and defend without fouling.
Second free throw. Yes.
All right, defense without fouling. Keep them out of the lane on the dribble.
74-68 Auburn. Murrell penetrates to the hole, drives and scores. Timeout Ole Miss. Oh, was that a foul? Oh, they called a foul on the play.
Gee whiz.
And Murrell can cut the lead in half with 26.3 seconds in the game. Broome called for the 3rd foul.
Said he hit him in the head. Maybe he did. I don't know.
Boy, if he got him.
He didn't get him.
And now Murrell can cut the lead to 3 with 26.3 seconds to go.
All right, the main thing is block out in case he misses. The other thing is get the ball inbound to a free throw shooter.
He's 8 of 9 from the line tonight. He missed it. He got his own rebound. It's Ole Miss ball, left corner 3, shot missed. Rebound again, Ole Miss. White right wing 3, good. Holy cow, the lead is 1.
Get it into a free throw shooter.
Inbound comes to Wendell Green. 15 seconds to go. Wendell across midcourt, penetrates and drives, and he's fouled. White's three from the right wing cuts the lead to one. A four-point trip down the floor for Ole Miss.
All right, nobody get into the lane. Make the free throws.
17 offensive rebounds for Ole Miss tonight. 16 second chance points. Yeah. Auburn by one, 11 and a half seconds to go. And Wendell Green Jr. at the free throw line for two for Auburn.
Our perimeter players have got to do a better job of rebounding. We're making other teams' rebounders look great on the perimeter.
Free throw by Wendell Green. Good. Woo. Timeout, Auburn.
He's got to tell the team two things, what to do against a two-point lead, what to do against a three-point lead. And he will get it right.
11 and a half seconds to go. Plenty of time for Ole Miss.
Yeah.
Regardless if Wendell makes the free throw or not.
That's right. They've got enough time to get what they want, but you know what? You ain't got a defense for both plays.
Both teams are 6 of 17 from the three-point line tonight. Auburn from the free throw line is 19 of 21. Ole Miss is 19 of 30 from the free throw line. And Wendell Green Jr. comes out for an enormous free throw that would give Auburn a three-point lead with 11 and a half seconds to go.
Yeah,
Green, Flanagan, Jasper, Williams, and Broom, the Auburn starting five. Murrell, White, Brakefield, Burns, and Allen, the starting five, well, starting five other than White, who replaced Abram.
You got to have a defense for the three-point shot, a defense for the two-point shot, make sure everybody goes to the board.
All right, knock home the free throw, Wendell. 20 points tonight for Wendell, 2 rebounds, 4 assists. 21 points would give Auburn a three-point lead. He got it.
All right,
hit the iron, hit the backboard, fell through.
Do not foul a three-point shooter.
Three-point lead, Auburn, full length of the floor to go. Murrell will bring it up the floor across midcourt. 7 seconds, knocked away and a foul by Wendell. Well, it puts a three-point shooter at the free throw line for two.
I think they might have called that for the bench. I'm not sure.
Third foul on Wendell. Murrell to the line for two for the Rebels.
That is one of your choices. Foul him, only give him two and get the ball back, or instead of giving him a chance to make a three, which is you take what you get.
Chris Moore will come in for Auburn after the first free throw by Matthew Murrell, who has been sensational for the Rebels tonight. He's 8 of 10 from the free throw line.
Now you got to defend that rebound coming off. He might make the first and miss the second, you never know.
He missed the first one. That wasn't in the plan. That wasn't in the plan, I guarantee you.
Would you make it? The next one, I might miss it and try to get a chance for it.
Well, yeah. By the way, Moore is in replacing Jasper. Got to think Ole Miss with 6.3 to go has to miss this one and get a rebound and then get a three-point shot to tie the game.
Don't get in the lane too quick now.
Murrell's second free throw, he made it. And now Auburn's got to get the ball inbound.
Inbound to a free throw shooter.
They get it inbound to Wendell, and he's fouled by White with 5.3 seconds to go. And Wendell will go to the line to try and give Auburn a four-point lead with 5.3 seconds to go, leading 76-74. What a struggle for Auburn tonight. And credit Ole Miss. Man, they've got two SEC wins, and they've come in here tonight with nothing to lose. Had a five-point lead at one time here in the second half.
Yeah.
But Wendell Green Jr. could put this one away at the free throw line and 5.3 seconds to go.
Yeah, they are well coached every game. They play hard in every game. They're playing in the best league in the country.
Auburn has shot 90.9% from the charity stripe tonight. Green is 9 of 10. Green is 10 of 11.
I'd say Green's been a valuable player today. What would you say?
I would agree.
Thank you.
He scored 23 the first time around. He has 22 tonight. He could match that 23 with this free throw right here and 5.3 seconds to go. And Auburn leading now 77-74. He can make this a four-point game. Nobody down the sideline for Auburn, only Ole Miss. Free throw. Got it!
Yeah, just don't foul him.
Inbound.
Don't foul him.
Cross midcourt, Murrell. Three ball. in and out. Auburn wins. Auburn survives tonight.
They survived. That's a good point. That was made it a half-court game, kept themselves in the game with a half-court game, and we survived a half-court game.
The Tigers improved to 19-9 overall, 9-6 in the SEC, and Auburn moves ahead of Vanderbilt in the standings in the Southeastern Conference. Vandy lost tonight at LSU. Final score from Neville Arena, Auburn 78, Ole Miss 74. Stay tuned. The Regions Bank postgame show is next.